What's up, guys? Grim here, bringing you the Godlike Arena Part 2. And this time we're packed full of awesome competitors, much like the last time, but maybe even better this time. In channel with me, I've got Crystal and Landslide helping me commentate this event and also paying our respects to Jungler.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
And there you go. We're going to make sure that we pay the proper respects to Junlar, and we're going to have Landslide give a little bit of a speech and let us know about this great PvPer that a lot of us knew and a lot of us got to play with and really enjoyed our time with. And then we will have a moment of silence. And this godlike arena is dedicated to you, Junlar. Go ahead, Landslide.
Well, first off, I'd just like to thank everybody for coming out here. Not only for the sake of remembering Jumar, our friend, and what he meant to each of us, but also, to show your support for the PvP community. Much like an event like this can do for us. Hopefully, in the future, we can get something else going and still have some continued support from the development team at Tryon. Of all the people I've met in Rift, and Lord knows, there's been a few. Jomar was the one person whose opinion really mattered most to me. In PvP especially, as I'm certain with any aspect of an MMO, sometimes we can all be a little bit volatile towards each other, and Jamar was one of the few people that never went that way. No matter who you were, he was always straightforward and honest with you, and he was also quick to help anyone out and very patient if anybody was seeking any type of advice. It's the type of person that there really isn't that many of in the game, and he was a dear friend of mine. I know a lot of people here they're very close with him as well. There was a lot of times when we were together, we'd be in a Warfront or CQ, and we just felt unstoppable. Like our play styles were so similar, we would just jump in and take on everybody and just have a great time. He's certainly a loss for the Rift community. And he's going to be missed on both sides of the battlefield. That's one thing I'm certain of. I kind of like to say, in life, there will always be people that we lose. Some will be earlier than we would have liked. And I think from this moment, in Jemar's passing, that maybe we could all take a step back and look at ourselves and ask ourselves, what is it that we can do to make an impact to our community? Much in the ways that Jenlar did when he was still with us. Maybe even if it's just taking 10 minutes to teach some new player a spec who's asking out in 10, maybe we skip a CQ to help a pal out with a quest or some other little menial thing to us, but something that could be of huge importance to somebody just starting out. Whatever it is, we should all try to take a page out of Jenlar's journal and try to be more helpful to one another. Let's try to build our community to something that's a little bit more meaningful than just all these forum epic troll battles that we seem to have on a daily basis. Maybe in Jomar's memory we can move past that. One thing that Jomar was great at is he always wanted to remain competitive. He kept a journal and he took a lot of notes about raid comps, different specs, even different dealings with other people. And he just wanted to be better. And he wanted to help push other people to be better as well too. That's what he always wanted. He just wanted a good fight, a good honest fight. And today with this tournament, let's remember that and celebrate it. Let's have a good honest fight in the name of Jomar. And rest in peace, Jomar. We'll never forget you, buddy. We all loved you. And to the contestants today, once again, I'd like to say thank you for coming and honoring my friend. It really means a lot to me. and to a lot of us at Moonbest. So thank you for that. Good luck today, and may the odds be in your favor.
All right. That was a great speech, Landslide.
That's all I got.
All right. We're going to follow that up with a moment of silence, because I think it's definitely deserving of that. All right. See you guys in 1 minute. All right, as you can see, Kaylee is speaking in Yale there, saying, "May we never forget Junlar and celebrate his life with a tournament worthy of this gentleman. Will the first teams please take their respective places now?" In the first round, we've got Iswin and friends against Team Slow Shots. And on Iswin's team, we have Iswin, CSX, and Franz.
I gotta find, where's the roster? I gotta pull that up real quick.
And on the opposing side, we have Team Slow Shots, which is Slow Shots, Anticity, and Neffy. Now, if you guys are familiar with any of these guys, if you've watched the last tournament, you know that Iswin's team can really dish out the DPS. I mean, you've got Franz, it was an excellent healer in the last tournament. So if he can keep the DPS alive, then yeah, they're going
to
be doing.
Yeah, that's true. Franz is a very capable cleric. I'm not sure what spec he's going to be running here, but that's a good combination for him to be running. He's using. I remember him from a while back, and he's one tough cookie too. But on the other side, you got Slow Shots and Neffy, and you know they're no slouch either, brother.
Now, the curious part about this other team is there's no cleric on this team. There is Rogue, Warrior, and Warrior. So, one of them are going to be rolling the healing spec. Alright, what do we have here? We got Iswin focusing on Slow Shots. Fairy Healer out on the board. And, let's see, we got Anticity and Neffy both focusing on CSX.
Now, this is basically an anything goes type match.
Pretty much, yes.
It's like they're trying to take down CSX first. He's under some pretty heavy fire,
yes.
But he's still staying up.
He is under very heavy fire. He's been pretty much at half health this entire fight so far. Slow Shots is also receiving a lot of focus. Neffy is... Oh,
they gotta take out those Liberators, right?
Yeah.
Physicians.
Let's see, what do we have?
Now, there were no soul restrictions, right? People could
right.
run the
oh,
new
okay.
soul
restrictions.
Iswin just went down.
I believe you're allowed to B-res.
Yes, you are. Franz getting a lot of pressure. Neffy and Anticity is not letting up.
Neffy and Anticity is not letting up.
I went Franz.
Yep. So, it's just a clean up now. CSX is hitting the ground now. Wow. All right. That's an interesting match there. Yeah, I was kind of wondering how much damage.
Looks like they had slow shots on Physician over there doing keeping those two powerhouses up on that side.
Yeah. Was definitely a very good combination over there. Interesting match. I mean, so which one was running the Liberator? Was it Slow Shots?
I misspoke as Physician. My bad.
Slow Shots?
I don't know. I can't. Oh, I'm trying to click him. I can't reach him from here to see if one of them was running Physician.
Yeah, he's running Rogue, so is Physician over there. Wow. Okay, we're getting to see the new souls in action.
Yeah.
Very, very cool. I was wondering if anybody was going to run them.
Well, I imagine any rogues who know anything about the state of balance right now would be running. Would be hard put not to run a position. They're pretty boss right now.
So these matches are the best of five right now. So one team has to win 3 out of the 5 matches in order to proceed to the next round. Both teams have signaled that they are ready. Yep. And the second round is underway. Are they going to focus the healers once again, or are they going to try to burst down DPS? Franz is already getting focused by Neffy and Anticity. CSX is getting the free cast. Franz is still taking a lot of pressure, but he seems to be keeping at around 80% health, which is not bad at all. He's trying to kite around Neffy and Anticity and keep his heals up, but he's down to 30% health or so. Man, look at the pressure being put on Franz right now. Slow Shots being able to just free cast back there until Izwin got on him right then. Franz is still getting all that pressure on him. Neffy and Anticity is not letting up whatsoever. Slow Shots is only being focused by Izwin right now.
Yeah, they're going to have a hard time taking him down by the Dominator, that's for sure.
Well, this is a very good round, though. No side is going down very fast. Both are standing a very good chance of winning this. Franz is just taking too much damage, though. I cannot see him being able to withstand this much longer. CSX is still being
able to see him on MP.
What was that? Well, at least CSX is being CC'd a little bit now, but he was being able to free cast all he wanted. Slow Shots once again lost Izwin, so he is being able to free cast all he wants while the focus is still being put on Franz like crazy, and CSX is CC'd now.
Yeah,
Franz is going down. It doesn't look very good for him. I imagine the mana is running low as well.
I'm surprised he stayed up this long.
Yeah, that is a lot of pressure.
He's still hanging in. He's full health. He's getting a little bit of his mana back. We might have been wrong about that guy.
The interesting thing is that CSX has been able to free cast this entire time, but is it going to be able to save Franz with added pressure on the others? Izwin taking quite a bit of damage himself. He's about 50% health and now back up to about 90 in full health.
You're another team, you gotta be asking yourself, what does it take to kill this guy?
Yeah, Franz is just tanking through all this damage and just trying to stay alive. Luckily, he doesn't have to focus too much on his allies because all the focus
That's
is just
impressive.
On him.
Now, what kind of spec do you think he's running to be able to actually take that kind of damage?
Let's see.
Well, he's got Brother in Arms thrown on him by Azusan, so that's helped keeping him up from them being able to burst him down. He's running, what, Subtle Invocation, Crucial Invocation, so that's what, Sandal?
They're doing a very good job of CC and CSX more now. He's not able to free cast as much as he was before, but Franz is still being focused a lot. Finally, Neffy is switching to CSX. The free casting's going to be stopping now, I imagine.
Yes, it's starting more and more to look like this might end in a draw in this match.
Slow shots is being focused by Iswin.
Somebody keeping time.
Anticity is still on Franz, but now you've seen Franz be able to survive two people on him at once. I don't know.
Is there a time limit on each mat?
I hope so. I don't want to be here all night. As much as I love PvP tournaments, I mean, you know, some of these are some of the people playing that could go on forever.
I wonder what kind of spec CSX is running right now. Okay. Kalia said, if games go to 15 minutes, it will be a stalemate. In the next round, they have to have one healer. Oh, they are running more than one healer on that team. So that would be Iswin's team, wouldn't it? Iswin and CSX are both running... No, it's CSX and Franz are both running Sentinel Clerics right now. So that's... Was the rules that you could only have one healer, or was it that you couldn't have three? I believe it was...
I'm looking at the original post, and it says three healer teams were not allowed.
Okay, so you could run two healers. I wonder if this
is
going
to
have
to scroll through if anything changed.
Yeah, this is... going to be a very long match then if there's multiple healers on one team. Kalia says you can have three. Okay. Alright, so I believe what she is telling me is...
I'm thinking we should just go ahead and call this one a stalemate.
I believe what I'm being told is that if it goes to a 15-minute stalemate, the rule is that the teams can only have one healer for the next round.
Yeah, we might want to lower that time limit.
Yeah, this is a lot of healing going on. It's almost hard to commentate this whenever nobody's going down. There is a lot of focus on Franz, but, you know, if CSX is able to just cross-healing, you know, what good can they do?
Well, if they're going to take down Franz and CSX, they're going to have to eat through their mana, and it doesn't look like they're being able to get that taken care of. And then on the flip side, Usen doesn't have enough DPS to get past that Liberator and the rest of their team, so...
And don't misunderstand me. Whenever I say they're not taking damage, I mean as in they're not going down. So. Yeah, they're still trying to pressure Franz a lot, but with cross-healing going with just three people, it's hard to imagine that he's going to go down. Because anybody that knows this opposing team, you know, with Anticity and Neffy, knows that the DPS is just being dished out onto Franz right now. And with a cross heal, he's not going to be able to go down. Well, Iswin's taking quite a bit of damage now. But he's got two healers, so. Which explains a lot of why Slow Shots was never getting focused, because they had two healers. Oh, CSX, look at that. Is he going to go down? No, full health almost immediately. Well, up to 80% or so.
DC?
Yeah, that's what I'm curious. Why? Where is the sixth competitor?
I want to see five guys.
I don't see Franz.
Yeah, where did Franz go? Did he? Surely he didn't die, did he?
Oh, Franz died.
Did we miss that?
Somebody died. They're up there on the top.
Wow, all three of us missed that. I guess we expected nobody to die and we wasn't paying enough attention. Alright, so Iswin's down as well.
Iswin just bit the dust.
Yeah. So I guess that's the match right there.
Yep.
Wow. We really didn't expect anybody to die there. But sure enough,
I think they finally were just able to get their mana starved down to the point where they could burst them.
Yeah, that must have been what happened.
Well, Slowshot's team only needs one more win for this first bracket to be all written up and on the board.
Yep, it's the best of five, so three wins are required. Oh, are they ready? Yes, they are starting the third round here. All right, let's see what's going on here. Hopefully it's not that long of a match again, because that was definitely a matter of them running out of mana in order to die. So, all right, let's see where the focus is. Neffy and Iswin. Franz is taking a lot of damage once again, and Franz is down. Wow, first one to die again. He is normally such a tank. They must have really decided to stack the damage heavy on him, because, well, the CC must have been going off really good on CSX for the cross healing to not happen, unless he changed spec. Let's go into first person view. I'm just noticing that I wasn't in first person view, so. Alright, CSX is taking a lot of damage from Neffy, and it looks like Antisti is focusing too. Oh, are they switching to Iswin a little bit? Slow Shots is just able to free cast over there all he wants. There is no focus on him at all. Iswin about to go down right now. The damage from Neffy and Antisti is just insane for them to be able to bring down Franz the way they did.
Yeah, because Franz died, he's eliminated out of the rest of the matches, correct?
Yes. Well, as long as his team loses, so. And it's just the cleanup crew now. Slow Shots has been able to freecast all he wanted from the back. There was almost no CC affecting him because the pressure was so hard onto the other team. So it's a 3-0 win by Slow Shots, Neffy, and Anticity. And they're asking for the Game 2 teams to get ready. It is going to be BDP, which is Torhid, Duditz, and Dibs against 1v1 Owned, which is Ganked. And Norxy, I believe that's how you say the name, and Revert. I believe there's quite a few people that are rooting for 1v1 Owned to win this entire tournament, so we'll see if the predictions hold true. I don't know their specs. They change specs. They are allowed to run any spec they want, which the classes are Torhid is a warrior, Duditz is a mage, Dibs is a cleric, and on the other team we have Ganked, which is a rogue, and Noxy is cleric, and Revert is a mage. I'm being told that Slow Shots is running at least over 15 points in a Rift Stalker, making him really tanky with Physician. Alright, this match has started. Now let's see what's going to be happening here. Torrid is obviously focusing in Norxy right now, while Ganked is on Dibs really hardcore right now. So Dibs is trying
Ganked
to kite
is,
around.
Dibs is... Yeah, you're going to have to watch out for that Ganked guy. He's pretty nasty. You definitely don't want him on you.
Yeah, he dishes out a lot of DPS, that's for sure. And he's not letting up on Dibs one bit.
Looks like Reaper's getting that mana down pretty quickly, along with Ganked. Dibs is about... Oh.
Torrid is trying to put as much pressure as he can on Norxy. and doesn't seem like he's switching targets ever. He's pretty much just going to keep the pressure all on one person right now. Which, Torrid's taking some damage now.
Gaint is staying on dibs.
Yeah, he's not letting up. And Orksy at about 30% health right now. But he's able to just stand away, and Torrid got turned into a squirrel. Who's... okay, is it Duddits free casting back there? Duddits is squirrel right now.
Revert's doing his best to keep the other team CC.
Yeah, he's doing a very good job of it.
He's got Diz mana down, though. Diz might be in trouble here. No mana.
Yeah, that would be definite way to bring down these healers, because that's been the big problem in all of these matches, is who can bring down the healer first. And with a Dom free casting, that would be the way to go.
I think Dibs might be... Dibs is going to eat it. I think he's gone.
And Orksy is just as low right now. Both are really
right now. Both are really low.
Oh, there goes Dibs.
Oh, man.
Oh, and looks like we got a... no, he was able to get out of the squirrel. Revert had Torrid and Squirrel there for a second. Gave him the time to get a breather.
Yep, so both of the main healers
are down. So both of the main healers are down.
Yep, there goes their Dom. Now it's just Torrid. He ain't going to last much longer.
No.
He might get Revert, though.
He did get Revert very, very low, but didn't finish the job. And Gank's team, with Gank, Denorxy, and Revert, 1v1 owns the first round. So, what all's your thoughts on the new souls right now? What do you think about the four new souls?
Well, I think Physician can expect a nerf incoming sometime in the near future.
Yeah.
I mean, you got biofeedback, and that's costs 3 energies, 5-second channel. It's on a 1-minute cooldown. It restores 23k health over 5 seconds and reduces damage by 15%. Let's throw that in with emergency response. It's a 1-minute cooldown. Restores health equal to 100% of the rogue's maximum health, and it absorbs about 1.2. So, you know, that's going to get hit by the PvP mitigation, which is 62%. So you're going to lose 62% of that healing in the shields, but still pretty good. But then, you know, you also got something called intensive care. All healing absorption increased by 50% for 10 seconds. I think that might be what's broken with the physician, in my opinion.
Yeah, it seems like the consensus is pretty much the same. Everybody in chat is saying nerf physician right now. So,
yeah. It's a lot of fun, though, man, right now. So, you know, I'm glad that they put the souls out to start with so everybody can enjoy them a little bit before, you know, they bring in the reins. I just feel bad for myself in the mage community because, you know, haven't really found a good use for Arbiter yet in PvP.
Yeah. Yeah, unfortunately, that's kind of what usually happens with the heavy tank souls. You know, the PvP, they always kind of struggle a little bit, so...
Well, you know, I know I have a lot of PvE friends, and, you know, I'm with Vendetta, so I know they're pretty excited about it. So, you know, I'm happy for the people that are going to join. It's going to be a great soul for tanking. You know, some of us were just hoping it might be able to hybrid well with the rest of the mage souls, kind of like Warlord does for Warriors. But, you know, we'll see. Kirby's going to take a look at it. I know he's also taking a look at Stormcall in the future. Real soon future, I hope. And, you know.
All right, the second
round. I'll tell you what, Oracle's...
the second round.
Oracle's really nice, too, man.
Wow, look at the damage being put on the Dibs right now. Ganked on him once again. Duddits is just free casting now, whereas Inorxia is as well. Revert made himself very obvious by going into split personality there.
Well, they about drained Dibs' mana.
Yeah, Ganked is really making sure that he's draining. He's getting Dibs down as much as possible. Torrid is squirreled over to the side. He's being CC'd very, very well.
I'm telling you, Revert, He's one of those guys you gotta watch out for.
And Norxia is being CC'd over to the side as well. Dibs is still taking a lot of pressure from Ganked.
Yeah, I don't think he's got many cooldowns left. He's probably about to bite it right here.
Yep, down goes Dibs there. Which Torrid's trying to put some pressure on the Wow, you see how low Revert got all of a sudden?
Yep, it's NRX kicking in right there. Just when you think you have somebody, that guy sneaks up and heals him.
Yeah. Torrid's got a lot of pressure on him right now.
Looks like he's 1v1's last victim.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Save the best for last.
Yeah, Duddits is trying to 1v3 these guys, I guess. But unfortunately, yep, it's not going to pay off.
Sorry, Duddy. Ain't got you, buddy.
And it's 2-0 so far for 1v1 owned. So, yeah, these matches are going a lot better than, you know, the two healer stacking. This is a lot more exciting, that's for sure. I'll go ahead and read off the rules since we didn't do it before the event. So, for anybody that's curious, the rules are all classes and specs are legal, including the new souls. Number 2, all gear is legal. Number 3, all consumables are legal. Number 4, we will wait up to a 2-minute cooldown for cooldowns to be ready per match. Number 5, going out of the arena during a match is a DQ. Number 6, soul walk is not allowed. Number 7, no running back into the active game if you have been killed. Number 8, battle res is legal. Number 9, 3 healer teams will not be allowed due to time constraints. Number 10, using Jet's Bounce Master 5000 is a DQ. Number 11, disconnects are unfortunate, but there will be no rematch redos if a player DCs during the active game. And the 12th rule is if a match in a series goes over 15 minutes, it will be called a stalemate, and the next match between those teams will be limited to one healer per side. All right, this third round is underway, and once again, we're seeing the same strategy. Ganked is really focusing on Dibs, and
yeah, it looks like the same strategy. They're both trying to go after each other's cleric first. And it looks like the same scenario as last time. Dibs is taking a little bit harder.
Yeah, what we're noticing is Revert is really doing a lot of squirreling this time. There has already been, what, 4 squirrels casted so far?
I see 2 squirrels, and if you're a mage and you're squirreled, you got to be asking yourself, what did I do wrong?
Yep.
I guess not every class has a million break threes. I think mage, you probably get 3 if you're lucky.
Well, both sides...
None of these guys can be running that spec, that's for sure.
Yeah, both sides are using the Dominator tricks up the sleeves right now.
Yeah, Dibs is dangerously low on mana trying to recover, and his HP is dipping fast.
Yeah.
He's gone. He's not going to survive that.
Yeah, the pressure is definitely on him. Oh, they CC ganked just in time. Maybe it saved Dibs.
I'm surprised he's been up this long, really. He should have been dead already.
Yeah, they're really doing a good job of slowing Gank down a little bit, but Dibs is still in so much trouble right now.
Nah, that's it.
Yep, yeah, he goes down.
That guy fucking held out, though. Shit.
Yep. Torrid's getting a lot of damage now as well.
Yeah, he's gone.
And down goes Torrid. So Duddits is the only one alive on the opposing team. All right, this is the third matchup here, and we got 2 deeps, 1 cup, which is Cupcakey, which is a cleric, Crumbonic, which is a rogue.
Naked, that's Cupcakey's team.
Yeah, Naked Stone, which is a warrior, against Benil and friends. Benil is a cleric, RG the rogue, and Autumn's the rogue. So we got two rogues.
Oh, it's no secret what team I'm rooting for here.
But this is going to be a really good match here because, as you see, the last time RG's team stacked rogues as well, and this time they're doing it once again. So the mana draining is probably going to be pretty heavy on that side. Which, the same matchup on the other side. They're just minus viral this time, but yet they put another rogue in the spot on two deeps, one cup, which is Crumbonic. So are they going to use the same strategy that
won? Does anybody know, is this the same team Cupcake he had last time? Or is it a substitution?
The only change is they took out Viral because he was busy for the tournament, and they replaced him with another rogue, which is Crumbonic. And most likely Naked Stone is going to be running his Paragon spec once again. Alright, this match is underway. Naked Stone, Cupcakey is in, and Crumbonic stealth over there to Benil. So Naked Stone is focusing on Benil, whereas Cupcakey
Benil's taking heat pretty fast.
Yeah, RG and Autumns is trying to put as much pressure on the Cupcakey as possible, but Cupcakey is very good at kiting.
I don't know. Benil's.
Yeah, Benil's smoked, taking son. A lot. Yeah, Naked Stone and Crumbonic is just really putting the DPS onto Benil right now. As you can see, it's still the same focusing on the clerics, and it's all about which side can drain the mana or else put enough pressure on the cleric to make it where they can't heal the rest of the team. It's just a focus on keeping the cleric alive at all
costs. Yeah, but I think Cup's team has got their DPS burst a little more coordinated than RG's team.
Benil just went down.
And here comes
Autumns. Autumns was near death right then. Still near death. And he goes down.
And he goes down.
I'm saving the best for last, Mr. RG.
RG is about to go down as well. It's just the cleanup crew right now because
he's hanging in there a little bit. There he goes.
Yeah. Very good match.
Very good match.
Yep, that's a good one.
1-0 win for two deeps, one cup so far. And for those that don't know, RG was very, very generous with a prize pack for the winners of this tournament. Some of the things that he donated was a Black Garden Dimension Key, 300 Platinum, 24 Exceptional Whetstones, 6 Epic Lockbox Keys, 3 Relic Lockbox Keys, 3 rare lockbox keys, and a lustrous intrepid ruin. So yeah, he added to the prize pool pretty big for the winners.
Well, it's always nice to see somebody making that type of contribution to an event like this. So, hats off to you, RG, for helping support the PvP community. It's a good thing, brother.
Absolutely. Which the prize pool for the winning team is just insane. If you guys have not seen it on the forums yet, yeah, it is something to behold because there are a lot of contributors towards this, such as 6 Rex are provided to the first team, which is 2 per team member. We got 6 160% token tablets. Of course, RG's prize pack. Ocho's prize pack, which is 3 of the 2.7 soul codes. Yeah, that's just for the first place. And I read off all the stuff that is in RG's prize pack. So that's a lot of stuff. Prizes for second place is 3 Rex, 3 of the 160% token tablets. And prizes for third place is 300 platinum. And all players that enter get a rune unsocketing apparatus, and all semifinal teams will get 12 depleted supply crates. Alright, this match has been signaled for a go. And let's see, Naked Stone goes straight after Benil, and Krumbonic goes into stealth and comes up to Benil and focuses in as well. So both of the DPS on both sides are just focusing on the healers, whereas Benil looks like he's going down the fastest. At 50% health right now and trying to get away.
Isn't that what you're supposed to do in PvP, though, is take out the healer first?
Sometimes.
Well, in this situation, you're definitely going to want to take out the healer.
Yeah. Unless you can CC really well in order to burst down a DPS, whereas the healer may be CC'd.
Yeah, beforehand. People have gotten a lot better at cleansing these days, so there went Benil.
Benil goes down. They're still trying to apply a lot of pressure towards Cupcakey, but with RG not having a healer, it looks like he's about to go down shortly.
That's a lot of bunny hopping going on right now.
Yeah. Cupcakey is very good.
Mr. Cupcakey.
And as you can see, they're still trying to put some pressure on Cupcakey, but Autumns is down now. So that's a 2-0 win. If they can pull out the third match, they will be moving on to the next round. And for those that don't know, we are doing, of course, the four quarterfinals, two semifinals, and then we're going to have a third place match before we go into the finals, and it will be a 5-minute break before the finals.
Now, how often do you guys do these tournaments?
It's all up to Godlike.
No, it's really whenever somebody really wants to take up the time to put it together. I know back in like last year, Hostile was the one that was mainly doing it, but at the onset of this dimension, you're starting to see a lot of other people come out of woodwork, which is really exactly what people were hoping would happen. So, the PvP dimensions, good job trying on that one. It looks like it's been a pretty good success, in my opinion.
It seems to be a runaway success, in my opinion. It seems like the players are really embracing it and putting it to good use.
Oh, I'm having a blast just watching this.
And the next round is
now,
underway.
Here goes, it's like the last chance for RG's team to get on the board.
And Autumns went in the stealth to get the stealth attack in, and Benil is taking a lot of damage once again. The DPS is just crazy.
Looks like they were just warming up those first two rounds.
And look how well Cupcakey is able to kite. I mean, it seems to be that she's just always keeping a step ahead of the people that's on her. Benil is still receiving lots of pressure from Naked Stone and Krumbonic there. Benil still fighting for his life. It seems that he's pretty much staying at below 50% of health most of this match.
Yeah, Cupcakey's starting to get a little low on mana there.
Yeah.
She might be in a little bit of trouble right now.
Uh-oh.
Nope.
Benil. Look at Benil. Is he going to go down? And he
is
going
to go down. Dead.
Wow. And Autumns is down. Look at that DPS that was put on Autumns immediately afterwards.
I'm telling you, that's what makes that team so good right there. It's, switching targets together at the same time and bursting them down.
Oh my gosh, the DPS from this team is just insane. And for anybody that was familiar with the team matchups on the forums, there has been a late minute replacement with the team Kawhi. And Hyung, which was a warrior, is now being replaced by Velvish, which is a cleric. So, yeah, complete different game plan on that team. So the next matchup that we have is Crowbar Crowd Control, which is a Bordicus, a rogue, Nightmarish, which is a rogue, and Pompeezy, which is a cleric. And Pompeezy was a late minute replacement as well. So on the opposite team, we have Kawhi, which is this team. This name is very hard for me to read. It's Alessinexo. I guess I'll just pronounce it Alessin whenever it's underway here. That is a warrior, and we got Verity, which is a cleric, and Velvish, which is the last minute replacement, which is also a cleric. And this is being called
now,
underway.
Now, all these are players that have played together for a while, or are they made up of people that may not have had a set group?
I think there's a lot of teams here of people that usually group together, and I think there are a few that just recently decided to kind of do something like this and train a little bit harder. And there's really a lot of things that come into play when you're in matches like this, as opposed to just queuing into a Warfront or a CQ. You really have to teach yourselves to be able to switch targets quickly and effectively. CC targets, not DPS those with AoEs, so that way they stay like squirreled or whatever. So yeah, but I'll tell you what, I'm seeing a lot of people that I know that I play a lot with that are just really good PvPers. So this is really a nice match to watch.
Yeah, Verity has gotten a lot of pressure during this match already, and it seems like they're really focusing on Nightmarish as well. So, is he running a Physician Soul right now?
No, it's too bad that the companions can't join in on this. I think that would be great.
Yeah. It's like a lot of buff stripping going on here.
Yeah. Nightmarish is just getting so much pressure put onto him right now.
Nightmarish seems to be under a bit of trouble.
Yeah, Verity and Nightmarish is definitely the two targets right now. But it seems like none of them is getting under too much pressure. I mean, they get down to around 50% health, but they're able to heal up. So the pressure isn't too steep right now. But as everybody knows, that can wear down as the match goes. As people start getting their buffs stripped and also mana starts running low, that's whenever the deaths happen.
Yeah, it looks like both teams are really doing a good job here. You know, it's kind of neck and neck.
Yeah, it's Pompeezy taking a lot of
damage. Yeah, that's a quick switch target right there. They weren't able to respond. Pompeezy's down.
Yeah. Switch off of the healer and go straight to the DPS in order to burst him down without them being able to retaliate. Which Verity's still getting a lot of damage, and Nightmarish is still receiving a lot of damage as well, but they're able to kite really well, though. You see Nightmarish is always pulling away. Even though he takes a lot of damage, he's able to pull away. I never can say that guy's name. Alinskio. He is taking a lot of damage.
Yeah, this is
right
definitely
now.
A brawl.
Yeah. Aborticus is CC'd off to the side right now. Nightmarish.
Oh, that's their healer.
Yeah.
He's back up, though.
Yeah.
Playing his guitar over there.
Yep. A lot of pressure being put on the Lencio right now. And it's almost hard to commentate him because it's hard to say his name.
They're duking it out, aren't they? It's like Lesnos getting some focus fire right now.
Yeah, this is interesting.
That's a stratagem. If you can't kill the healer, go after the DPS.
Yeah, because Aborticus is running Physician right now, I'm being told, so.
Yeah, he's definitely healing the shit out of them. You know, that's a good spec he's pulling out, probably for heals. The way that spec is running is, it's hard to beat.
The suspicious sheep out there. Pompeezy going over to Verity. Which Pompeezy is almost going down. There's a lot of pressure being put on him, but yeah, this is kind of interesting. They keep switching targets.
Oh, it might be seeing one of those 15-minute matches.
Yeah, but the good the good thing is
I think this one is going to be I think there might be some CD management over there on one of the other sides. So this might end in the next 2 or 3 minutes.
Which Verity is getting close to going down repeatedly, though. So this match could end abruptly, like we didn't think the first match was going to, but this one might be the same, where it drags out, but all of a sudden somebody gets burst down and killed. Yeah, somebody's pointing out to me that it seems kind of odd because Aborticus is not getting focused at all.
You cut out there.
Verity's still taking a lot of damage, but he's able to heal up every single time. Alright, there has been a new rule change. Now matches will only be able to go for 10 minutes. The 15 minute rule is overruled now, so 10 minutes is the deadline for a match to end.
That's definitely a smart ruling.
Yeah, especially before it really impacts a team. So,
well, I think if you can't kill him in 5 minutes, you're not going to kill him. Maybe 7 minutes would probably be a better idea.
Possibly,
you know,
but
we got a lot of matches on tonight. Let's get through them.
Somebody yelled, "Thank you for 10 minutes." Yeah, Chromebonic says that. Yeah, this one's definitely stretching out here. I'm curious if it's going to go to time limit or if somebody will focus on somebody else besides the main healers. Nightmarish, down to 50% health, as well as Verity. It's kind of odd seeing everybody running around with well over 50% health. You know, some of them are dipping down into the 70% area or whatever, but they're going right back up. Oh, Aborticus took.
Yeah, they should have some sort of sign contest or a side contest for whoever has the best companion. You know, kind of like Miss Congeniality for Rift.
Yeah. Five-minute warning has been given.
It just amazes me that people are still alive at this point.
Yeah, 5 minutes down.
Well, personally, I think this would have been over a lot sooner if they would have been focusing more on Aborticus. He's the one that's carrying them over there.
Yeah, as soon as I said that, my husband pipes up. He goes, "Oh, you're just used to being dead right off the bat," which is true. I try to PvP, and I'm on the floor automatically.
Yeah. Oh, Nightmarish goes down. Oh, the match just changed.
I think I jinxed.
Put more time on the clock.
Yes. Right after you say if they don't kill each other. If they don't kill each other in 5 minutes, they're not going to kill each other, and they kill themselves right after the 5 minute mark.
Well, they better hope they can get somebody else down before the that PRS timer is back up.
Yeah.
Maybe we should start counting deaths.
Yeah, that might be a way of going about it.
I know that physician, it has a battle res, but it's not a 5-minute cooldown, so at least that's one thing that physician sucks at.
Pump easy getting a lot of damage. Oh, pump easy goes down. Yeah, I was just about to say the pressure that was being put to him, and all of a sudden he's dead.
This is a pretty brutal match. Still anybody's game.
Mm-hmm. So far, Bordicus' team is the only one that has suffered any deaths at all, and they were able to battle res Nightmarish back up, but Pomp Easy is probably not going to get the same treatment.
Yeah, he's sitting up in the bleachers.
Yeah, it's a 3v2 match right now, so it's just a matter of time probably before the Abordicus' team
goes down.
Yeah, Abordicus is doing a really good job of keeping him alive. So I guess they're trying to go to his time limit, because I don't think killing the other team is what's going to happen. Nightmarish goes down.
I should say his main outfit.
Yes. So I guess they're just playing with him right now, or he's just a little bit difficult to kill at this moment. Abordicus, solo healing everything. I wonder if Verity and his team knows that they need to get Abordicus down before the time limit expires. If he's able to solo heal through this, he can make it go to a stalemate.
But how long do you think he can keep up solo healing himself like that with the three of them beating on?
Well, yeah, that is very, very true. And he goes down. The thing is that the 5-minute timer had been called a few minutes ago, so he didn't have too much longer that he needed to keep himself alive.
Yeah, well, the thing with that is, if somebody's going to die before the 5-minute timer, then, you know, obviously it's going somewhere, so I don't know.
Mm-hmm. So it's 1-0 for Kawhi. The team Kawhi. So how are you guys liking the matches? Is it going good for you guys? We're about to start the next round here. They've been given the go sign now. Give me a little bit of feedback, guys. How are you liking it?
Are you talking to the streamers or to us in the vent?
There's a lack of people in the vent right now. Landslide has already went to go smoke, so yeah, definitely to the people watching the live stream.
Yeah, I think he went to go for a smoke break.
Pump Easy getting a lot of damage put onto him right now at 50% health. Verity.
Yeah, I just told my husband it's too bad my son doesn't have time to play anymore. And wow, he was a big arena player, and the 3v3 and 5v5 matches, he would have eaten this up.
Yeah. Yeah, this is definitely very exciting to watch. As long as they don't stack healers, that's the only time it gets a little bit slow. But yeah, whenever the damage is being dealt, as you're seeing right now on the Verity, and it seems like Nightmarish is being focused once again. Verity's trying to play the smart game of line of sighting, but yeah, he's getting a little bit of distance between him and the people trying to hit him, so he's able to line of sight some, so the pressure isn't on him nearly as much as it was before. Pompeezy's trying to chase, but with Verity being able to kite the way that he has, it doesn't seem to be too much of a problem. Oh, as I say that, he goes to 50% health. Is nobody going to focus Abordicus once again? Yes, he's just standing at the bottom right corner, as you can see, casting away. A lot of pressure still being put on Verity. That seems to be the person that's taking all the damage right now. Nightmare is starting to take damage now. So, is Nightmarish? Yeah, Nightmarish is being chased by the entire other team right now. So,
all right, I'm back. What did I miss? Any action?
Yes, lots of people going down, and nobody's died yet, but the damage is pretty substantial on several people now.
Looks like they're focusing on Verity.
Yeah, Verity's getting all the pressure onto him right now. Which Nightmarish is getting some pressure, but he's doing a very good job of kiting and trying to make sure that he stays out of the focus as much as possible. Pompeezy down to 70% and back up to full, but it seems like Velish is putting a lot
of
damage.
I'm just watching Orcus trying to heal Pompeezy. Looks like he has some CC there. Couldn't get to him in time.
Yeah, Pompeezy went down.
He got back up, did he?
Nope.
Yeah, he's up there in the stands already.
It's definitely one thing you want to be doing is trying to hit that force respawn if you can. Mm-hmm. Get those guys out of the game before they can get battle res.
Yes, because that is one of the rules there, is that if you leave the arena in any form, such as force respawn or anything, then you are out of the match. So apparently, even though they're not focusing damage on Aborticus, they're doing a pretty good job of interrupting him, so...
Well, you know, it's not always about DPS. Sometimes it's about keeping somebody busy so you can hinder their ability to fulfill their role in their team.
Absolutely. Nightmarish getting close to going down. Wow. That teleported up there. Aborticus is doing a very good job of keeping Nightmarish alive. But how long is that going to last?
Wow, here comes.
I'm just now being told.
I'm being told
that Kiwi is about to join us in vent. So we're going to have another commentator to help out.
Yes, shout out. Hey, Kiwi.
Aborticus CC'd over to the side as a focus Nightmarish now. Oh, Nightmarish goes down. I was curious how long they were going to be able to keep him alive, but of course the break freeze just are not going to be happening too much with Aborticus. He could not keep Nightmarish alive. So now it's just a matter of DPS and Aborticus down 3v1.
Yeah, this should be a good display of what Physician is really capable of. See how well they can handle a coordinated three-team attack. Well, they got an interrupt on him when he was casting something there. I didn't quite catch it, but he might be in trouble now.
Yeah. There's only so long you can survive against three.
Oh, he's going to eat it? Oh, my God. How the fuck is he? There he goes.
Yeah, that was something else, being able to survive that long. The chat says, clearly this fight shows Physician needs a buff.
So now let me ask you, are all the PvP arenas basically the same, or have any been built with like obstacles or environment that people can line a sight on?
I'll tell you one thing though, Crystal. The way that this whole dimension thing, not only the PvP aspect, but also, you know, just kind of like... you know, your little piece of pine rift, you can make so many changes to the dimensions. You'd be surprised what was there before when they bought it and what they put in there. Like these corners, those are actually like steps that they just kind of set up to kind of make this arena look the way that it is. When you actually buy the dimension, it looks nothing like this. It looks exactly like the more or less the real estate in the game already.
And I'll tell you what, I'm very impressed with all of the Dimensioneers in the game and just the level of creativity that these folks have.
Oh, man, no kidding. There's a lot of talented people out there. I don't know if you've ever just taken like a drunk night like tour through them, but you know, you really find some really awesome stuff, like that guy with the spaceship, or I don't know if you've seen Cosmos, but this is pretty cool too.
Alright, the next round is underway here. Verity, once again, getting focused a lot. And Pompeezy is also going down to 50% health now.
Oh, Pompeezy's taking some heat.
Yeah, they're obviously switching it up on him. And Kiwi Bird's doing giveaways in the chat right now. Look at that. Patron passes. Nightmare is taking a lot of damage right now. Verity's doing a good job of kiting, which... Nightmarish, did he go DPS here? Or is he just kiting here? Seems like he was chasing Verity. It made me wonder for a second there. I don't want to pull up the buffs on people because it will cover up the screen, so... Verity, a 50% life and Nightmarish charging in at him. Yes, definitely some DPS going on there. So they swapped roles in order to switch up the tactics here to confuse the other team. Obviously it wasn't working before, so they changed up their game plan to make it possibly work this time. So Nightmarish is still on Verity right now, and Bordicus is not having any pressure on him, so he's obviously staying as Physician Spec.
Yeah, that's the guy I'd be after. That's a tough guy, though. I don't know if you've ever played with him before, but he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, Nightmarish is playing Sin Spec, I'm being told, right now.
I think about the only thing that's going to be taking down these positions is a good Dominator. They're just having... I mean, look at that energy bar. It's not moving. Staying above 50%.
Yeah. Nightmarish is doing pretty good DPS right now. Which Pompeezy is taking a lot of damage himself. Oh, Pompeezy is about to go down, and he is down right now. Verity just healed up all the way. Pompeezy is back alive. Look at that. The battle res is real.
That didn't seem to take too long this time.
Yeah, I think they've, got rid of the jitters, so now they're somebody's taking some heat right there.
Yeah, it's interesting because they're still doing a lot of focusing on Nightmarish, which is the DPS. So it's obvious that the the healers aren't the only focus.
I'm just laughing a little bit. They seem to all be doing this one big circle around the ring. It's like Ring of the Rosie with these guys. Look at that.
Yeah, Pompeezy is taking a lot of damage, but he's doing a pretty good job of kiting.
It's like Pompeezy's taking the heat right now.
Yeah. Which it seems like we're saying the same people because that's where all the focus is being put on right now. Pompeezy and Verity.
Which Verity's doing a really good job of using that real estate and making them use it to his advantage as well, too.
I was just about to say that with the one obstacle being there for the line of sight, they're really wearing that thing out right now. Nightmarish down to, well, he did go down to around 30% health there, but able to get healed up. Pompeezy back down to about 60% health and then healed right back up, so the 5-minute warning has been given. Pompeezy may be going down right now, and he is down. So Pompeezy goes down first this time as well. The Bordicus's team is in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, I think the other team is, I think Verity's team is just a little bit better with stripping buffs than the other team.
Yeah. Well, they're not, even it, with it being a 3v2 right now, the Aborticus' team is once again able to keep the heels flowing.
I'm telling you, this this team with Elvis Verity, and you know, that's gonna be a I don't really know the other guys so much, but I know Velvish is something to be a little bit worried about if you're going up against him next time.
So the interesting thing here is Aborticus has always been the healer on that team, but yet he's always been the last person killed. So
yeah, he's taking a lot of heat right now, trying to pump out casual treatment with no success. He keeps getting interrupted.
But the talk has always been that you just focus the healer first, and you know, you always focus the DPS after the healer is dead. That's how the all of these matches have been going. Even in the last tournament, that's how it's been going. But this time, it's...
Well, if you notice, now team's got somebody that's doing something in the utility sense that's giving you a little bit more of a headache, you might be better off taking them off first, like a Dominator. I don't really know what spec Pompezi was running, but I guess they thought it was a little more important to take them out first. Of course, the way this match has been going, I guess you just switch targets until you get somebody down.
Yeah. Try to trick up the healer a little bit. So it's just the cleanup crew once again. Yes, Aborticus is down. So that's a 3-0 win for Kawhi. So we're going in between. We are done with the quarterfinals right now. So we will be doing a giveaway. A giveaway of a Rex. So who wants to win a Rex?
And that was Crowbar that won?
No. Crowbar Control. Crowbar Crowd Control lost that match 3-0. So this is a 5-minute break. We will be doing a giveaway right now. Are you guys wanting a giveaway, or are you guys still trolling the chat? What are you doing? Do you want a giveaway or not? Go ahead and type something in the chat to where it will register you as taking part in this giveaway. And there are rules to this giveaway. You must be a follower. You must be following this live stream here. So if you're not live, if you're not following the live stream and we draw your name, you lose. Even though you win, you lose. Okay, we're about to do the giveaway here. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the winner is Zoe. So we're going to write down Zoe's name here, and then I will be sending you a message on Twitch, and we will get your character name and all of that stuff. So yes, you are the winner, Zoe. You are following the live stream, and we will be doing a giveaway in between each of the main rounds. So yeah. So that was some pretty interesting matches. I mean, we've seen the healer stacking. We've seen people that was really using the new souls instead of just going with the classical cleric. But we did see the cleric healers really standing out, such as Cupcakey was able to kite a lot and get the heals off.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man. Everybody's going to be keeping their eye out on the other team's rogues if they're running position or not.
Yeah. Yeah, so I wonder if they are going to let Physician stand for a while to test it out some more, or are they going to heed the advice of everybody and nerf it pretty soon?
Well, I think they're probably still dealing with some other bug issues from the, you know, such a big patch. But I think once they get through the bulk of that, they'll probably come back and do the PvP stuff. It's normally how they do it in the past, I think.
All right. They are calling for both teams to get ready, and the teams that are going to be up is Team Slow Shots, which is Slow Shots, which is a rogue, Anticity, which is a warrior, and Nephi, which is a warrior. And the other team is 1v1 Owned, which is Ganked, a rogue, Inorxia, I'm saying it wrong, cleric, and Revert, which is a mage. And we've seen Revert use the domination spec really well during their match.
Yep, so you got a team that's going to have, I don't know what the Warriors are going to run. One of them is probably going to be running Beastmaster, and you're probably going to have the Liberator. But, you know, you got Revert over there at Dom to stick that on the Physician. I'm not sure if Physician can keep up the cleanses. I don't know what that team's going to do.
Hmm. Yeah. And we've already seen...
definitely going to be trying to...
Well...
yeah, they're going to have to shut down that Dominator if they're going to be successful, so they're probably going to try and do that with BM.
Mm-hmm. Well, we know that Ganked is going to be dishing out a lot of DPS, and the other team with Nephi and Anticity is dishing out a lot of DPS with their Warriors, and they have the Physician.
Yeah, I'm definitely have to go 1v1. I think they just have better composition available to them to take on this other team.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Physician is pretty strong, but I don't think it's going to hold up to that team right there.
And both teams have said that they are ready, so the go sign has been given. And Nephi and Anticity charge forward, but keep the line of sight active. And the charge in happens. They are focusing on Revert. They're not wanting that Dom to get his castle.
Well, they start out with Mage, KZ9RX. They're trying to get ahead there for a second.
Mm-hmm. Nephi taking a lot of damage.
They're hitting Nephi hard.
Yeah, Ganked is on him, so you know the DPS is very, very high on him right now. And Slow Shots is CC'd over to the side. He is squirreled, so Revert is able to cast his CCs at will.
You gotta hate it when that happens.
Well, it seems like Nephi has survived the initial damage while they CC'd Revert.
They got Revert in the Mage Cage. Honorix is taking some heat.
Yes, he's taking a lot of heat. Is he going to go down? He keeps on getting bursted down to about 30 to 40% health.
It takes a lot of heat to get that guy down.
Yeah.
Looks like he's running Puri.
But
I don't imagine him getting hurt too badly.
Yeah, they're not letting up on the damage on Nephi, though. They're making sure that that DPS is not being able to run wild. Anticity getting a lot of pressure as well, but Ganked is not letting up on Nephi. Which Slow Shots is free casting to the side. Nobody's keeping any pressure on him, so perhaps he can keep his team alive. But Nephi is almost going down.
Nephi is about to drop.
Yes.
Slow Shots squirreled again.
Yes, that was the perfect CC.
That was the perfect CC.
Yep. That's some fucking... telling Revert, he's pretty nasty.
The clutch CC at the right time there.
There goes Slow Shot for another squirrel. How many break frees can you get in that spec? I guess not too many, because there he is.
Well, it looks like we know who the standout man on that team was this time. That was Revert.
There's nothing like a good Dominator.
Which, that was the interesting thing in the first tournament. The Doms really didn't do that good except for one team. You know, the one team that made it to the finals against Two Deeps, One Cup.
Yeah.
But this time, it seems like the Doms are standing out a little more.
I remember before that tournament, everybody was saying that Dom wouldn't be a good idea to bring, and I was kind of scratching my head at it because, you know, there's some pretty good things you can do with that. Also, I don't know if you ever saw somebody like Screamo run a Necro Dom, but... that's pretty nasty, too.
Can you guys hear me yet?
There you are.
Yes.
Aloha, aloha. Grim!
Hello! Glad you could join us.
Yes, it's been a while. Kiwi, how have you been?
It's been a while. It's, busy. As you have been, too. I've been watching your Twitter. Hello, everyone in chat. Kiwi Bird, you rock.
All right, since we got Kiwi in the chat here, let's go ahead and promote Kiwi a little bit.
Yeah, I caught some of your stream the other day.
So
I guess you were doing like a marathon streaming event for 2.7?
It wasn't meant to be that way, but try on, you know. kept me on my toes. It was meant to be 2.7 souls and then the setback.
Kiwi, give a shout out on your live stream. What's your live stream channel so people can visit you and be sure to be...
It's my name. Just click on my name. It takes you straight to my stream. I have a fun Sunday thing coming. Cheers, mate. I appreciate that. And you've been working hard. Awesome on the YouTubes.
Thank you. I haven't promoted myself at all yet, but that will be coming soon. I will be selflessly promoting myself like crazy, and everybody in chat can go AFK whenever that happens.
Right.
Oh man, and this match is underway once again, and you see Antisti going right into Inorxi. So this is, where is Ganked chasing right now? Is he focusing on Antisti? Yes. Oh, look at the health. And Inorxi almost went down. That was 0% health, and he pulled
off. That's pretty surprising. That kind of cleric doesn't get that low very often.
Wow, and he popped ugly at the last second in clutch fashion there.
Well, if you're on the other team, you're just hoping you can get him that low again before that cooldown is up.
The DPS was insane onto him, and man, he saved himself at the last second. He was going down. Nephi is being CC'd, and Norxy is still getting a lot of damage being put onto him. Revert seemed to be CC'd off to the side for a moment there, but he is back into full casting mode, and Slow Shots is squirreled.
Yeah, I'm starting to notice a lot of teams starting to utilize the Mage Cage. That might be a game breaker right there for some teams.
Yeah, Norxy.
Looks like Gank's running MB right now. Somebody's going to drop pretty soon.
Yeah, nope. He's trying to focus on Antisti as much as possible. He's pulled off, and who is he focusing on now? Is he switching to Nephi?
Antisti's doing a good job of got Antisti squirreled.
Yep. Revert is CC'd over to the side, so the Dom casting is not happening for that moment. Nephi is playing a game of Ring Around the Rosie with Inorxi, trying to get as much damage done as possible there. Gank seems to be focusing on Nephi a little bit. Oh, Gank to CC now.
I imagine that one little half second of line of sight would come in handy in a case like this.
Oh, it makes a very big difference. And Inorxi goes down.
All right,
and
Inorxi.
So the B res has happened and he's up again, but it's the same situation where he's having to flee for his life, basically. Revert, CC'd off to the side.
Yeah, but he's got a lot more mana now from that B res, so he might be in a better situation now.
Possibly, but the pressure is still on him like crazy right now. Nephi is not letting up on him. I imagine they're thinking he went down once. That's definitely the person to attack to make him go down again.
Well, Slow Shot just took a squirrel, so we might be seeing a change in the winds here. Slow Shot is back out. If the Gank's team is going to want to come out on top of this, you're going to have to figure out a way to get Slow Shot's energy drained down.
Hey, Grim, can you turn your oil, please?
The control U turns off all of the health bars. So, as you can see. Yeah, I talked about that earlier, so. I guess nobody heard it.
You can do a reloaded UI without one for another time.
Okay. Ganked is CC'd off to the side right now, and Nephi is still focusing on Inorxi. There is no letting up on him, which Slow Shots is still being able to stay off to the side and heal at will. nobody has really put too much pressure on slow shots right now. Revert, CC'd once again. And an Orksy is going down. Ew, is he going to get it? Is he? Yes, he goes down.
Yes, he.
So, yeah, he's out.
Yes. So Ganked and Revert are in a lot of trouble now. As you can see, Ganked is almost dead now. And there he goes. So now it's 3v1 on the Revert.
That's it for them. That was a good match, though.
So it's a 1-1 match. We're finally not seeing a sweep.
Haven't had one of those in a minute.
So, Grim, what is your Twitch channel handle?
My Twitch channel is GrimGamerTV. And if you guys are interested in winning some soul bundles on my YouTube channel, which is www.youtube.com, it's Grim Gaming Rift, which Grim the Gamer is coming up shortly, will be my second channel. So Grim Gaming Rift is the way to go if you want to win 4 chances of a soul bundle. And all of that is being provided by the guild Godlike Awesomeness. So if you go to my channel, which is Grim Gaming Rift, and leave a comment in the comment section below, you'll be entered in for a chance to win a soul bundle. And there are 4 of them being given out, and we've got 4 different videos. If you leave a comment in each one of them, that just adds to your chances of winning one. So yeah, go do that. You'll really love the channel too if you like PvP content. Despite what you trolls are saying, yes, I am a PvP'er. So. And if you're interested in seeing more of the other people that's in this commentary with me, be sure to visit their Twitch channels. We got Kiwi Dream, which is www.twitch.tv/KiwiDream. And then we have Crystal, which is www.twitch.tv/DJCrystal. And yeah, go check them out. You'll really enjoy the content. Crystal does a lot of radio show content, so on different games. So if you're interested in that kind of stuff, go check her out and you'll love it. Trust me. And this next match is about to be underway. They have been given the go sign. Let's see what they do here. The charge.
Oh, I lost you again. But thank you definitely for the shout out.
Crystal's amazing.
Yes, we need to get together soon, Kiwi, when we have a little bit more time.
We do, and Kiela sent me this, and I'm probably talking over Grim because I can't hear him.
No, I'm not talking right now. I'm letting you guys talk because Kiela, I'd be talking over you.
Oh, she gave me this vent. I thought she'd be here, so I was going to come in on to poke her face, but it's good to see some of our old PvPers in the channel as well. Hey, Yoke, Rick.
And I'm being told that slow shots must be running at least 24 points into Riftstalker for the skill planar reversal. Might be some physician Riftstalker hybrid. Wow, if I could talk, it'd be really great. So as you can see,
dangerous.
Yes, very much so. And as you can see, the Dom split personality is active. So that definitely makes you a focused target with Revert. They know he's a Dom. Yeah, they know he's a Dom, but whenever you go into split personality, you make it even more obvious that they need to be taking care of you. Revert, CC'd over on the side while a lot of pressure is being put onto Ganked. Which he went down to 50% health for a moment there, but slow shots casting away over to the side as well as Revert. Gank still getting a lot of pressure being put
on
him.
Trying to focus down Gank.
Which slow shots is being squirreled.
I'm not sure what spec NRX is running this match.
Yeah, ganked at 50% health once again. They're obviously putting a lot of pressure on him.
Yeah, we got Reaver on Chlorodon, that's for sure.
Okay. Which is an awesome dueling spec, generally. What's going on with Neffy over there? Are you guys seeing what I'm seeing?
Yeah, I think there might be a slight area over there that you can probably fall through, and they fell in like by that fence or some shit like that. Like, looks like there was a squirrel, and the squirrel walked him under the bricks over there.
So how have you been since the last tournament, Grim?
Been doing really well. Been really trying to work hard on the YouTube channel and trying to get these new soul videos out.
Which How's that going?
Yeah, I did first impressions of each. Do what?
Do you have Twitter?
Yes, I do have a Twitter, which is www.twitter.com/GrimTheGamer. So how have you been? I hear you've been live streaming a lot.
Yep. Having fun with it. I've got a fun project coming up. And lots of giveaways like this awesome channel is doing. Yeah, it's fun. And in Arcage a lot, but I'll be in Rift a lot more.
Which, did we lose all of our commentators besides me and you?
One went to have a sandwich, one went to get a drink.
Alright, this match
is... They don't expect us to do this sober, dude.
Aquafin, you're interesting. Congrats on winning the soul pack the other day.
So, we got this match finally underway. Hopefully no more glitches and people falling through the floor. So, let's see where the focus... Well, lots of focus on the game.
I got my eye on Revert. That's who I'm going to be watching this match. I'm going to see if he's able to do something against that BM and... position column they got running over there.
Yeah. Which a lot of pressure is still being put on Gank, but he seems to be getting healed up.
He's
really
trying
well.
To deal with the BM right now. BM has that, I think it's like an 8-second sleep or something like that. It's pretty nasty.
Yeah. So, slow shots off to the side and making sure that he's keeping any kind of line of sight that might be happening towards him. But I am assuming that he is still going to be the one healing on that team, correct? Neffy being CC'd. Revert is CC'd as well.
Yeah, they're really utilizing Mage Cage in this tournament. That's interesting. I don't think I've seen that in the previous ones too much.
Yeah, the squirreling is going on like crazy. Revert is really wearing it out on that. So it looks like Ganked is running Physician now, maybe some into Bard.
I tell you what, if you're gonna Mage Cage somebody, you might want to wait until you have a little bit more charge than that. That one lasted for like 2 seconds. Yeah, you don't want to be burning your CCs on somebody for, 2 seconds. That's just it's a waste.
It's really good strategy that they're using by swapping up specs in between rounds, so they're able to confuse the other team a little bit at least.
Oh, yeah, you definitely got to have that in a tournament like this. You know, you got to give the players the freedom to kind of go with their gut and make changes on the fly.
Okay, so what did I miss?
Maybe another glitch. Look, slow shots is stuck in the pillar. Look at this.
I just say advantage Dom on that one. I mean,
oh boy, the glitches. They're running rampant right now. So are we going to have another restart with this team?
I would kind of think you'd have to for something like that.
Yeah, that's the second
time. Well, the stakes are pretty big, so, you know, you want to be fair to both teams.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's the second glitch in a row.
But you got to wonder if the onset of these glitches is going to maybe be in the minds of some of the future dimension builders and the stuff that they put in the middle of their arena.
Mm-hmm. All right, seems like Slow Shots is out of the pillar and ready to go, so the go sign will probably be issued just shortly. The last tournament we had around 350 viewers because
here they go.
Trion was supporting it with
Let's
broadcasting
hope this one goes
in-game.
Smoothly. They put Revert right into the maze case, probably a full charge.
Yeah, they're already trying to control Revert some. Neffy taking a little bit of damage. Seems to be doing alright though. But no, going down to 50% health now. So the pressure is being put on him pretty soon.
Gank's trying to get Neffy down. He's taking some heat now himself.
Yeah, Gank switched back to Sin, so swapping it up on him so that the pressure can be diverted somewhere else and confuse the other team. Slow Shot, CC'd off to the side. Neffy's still getting a lot of damage, but Ganked also receiving a lot of damage. It seems to be a DPS fest between the two of them. And Norxy CC'd off to the side, but seems to have broken free from it, so.
And Tissy's taking some heat.
Yes. So is Neffy. Neffy is down to 20% health or so now. And he's real close to going down. Oh, he goes back up to 50%.
Oh, we got a squirrel on Slow Shot. They might get him down.
Is Neffy going down here?
They might have
him going down here.
I think they got him. Oh, Slow Shot's barely got out in time, but he's still kind of far away. That was close. They almost had him.
Revert. Oh, man, the pressure was on
Revert.
Oh, man,
the pressure was...
That's a two-minute cooldown you hate blowing, but you do when you have to.
Yeah, Revert was taking a lot of damage really fast there.
Well, they're really doing a good job of purging Nynarix. I think he's running Puri over there.
Which, they're putting a lot of pressure back on Ganked, and... Antisti is seeming to... Oh, Ganked is focusing on the Neffy right now. So Neffy is getting real low once again. Is the CC's going to be... Oh, CC'd Slow Shots again. But he got out just in time to keep Neffy back alive. And Norxia...
This team's really going
Norxia. Yeah. Dom is really
That's
playing...
A
Dom is really playing...
Yeah, Dom is playing such a big role in this match.
That's really going to be the only way you're going to get the positions down. It looks like Canarix is... There he goes.
Revert. Going down
Revert.
To 30%,
going
30% health or so. And the pressure is still on him really hard with Ganked.
That's a lot of trouble to be in after your guy uses his ugly already. Gotta be wondering if he's sitting on his Essence Surge still.
Yeah, Neffy isn't letting up on Revert
he's
right now.
He's in trouble. Hey, he's down.
And he is down, yes.
Looks like they're gonna get him respawn too, you know?
Ganked is CC'd over on the side while the other team is teeing off on Inorxia right now.
That was a good one.
Yeah. And Ganked is down. Very good match there.
Yeah, you know, those BMs, they're incredibly useful in this type of tournament, I think. I'd do a video on Arbiter, but it would be very boring, so. I don't think many people would enjoy it.
I did an Arbiter video already.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What did you do, just a 61?
Yeah, I just did the preset that it had, so it wasn't even PvP, you know, tweaked or anything like that. I basically just did it as a first impression.
What are you guys' HP?
Oh, what was the HP? I'm not sure.
Well, I haven't really ran a 61 build. I've been kind of experimenting with a few hybrid builds that have been ranging around 40 to 50k HP, you know, like 40-30 point bills.
All right, right off the bat, they're CCN and Norxia off to the side, and a lot of pressure put on Revert. He almost went down right at the beginning of the match.
Yeah, that was really close.
Yeah, they definitely wanted to get that mage out of the way. That was their game plan. They're hoping the mage cage Honor X and be able to burst Revert in time.
And it looks like Norxia is back into Puri. So, yeah. Interesting changes going on here. Norxia, CC, they are making sure that they keep him locked down. Anticity seems to be getting a little bit of pressure, but it doesn't seem to be too bad. Nothing that you can't handle so far. And Slow Shots is CC'd off to the side. The squirreling is still going rampant. Hopefully he doesn't get stuck in a pillar. Anticity seems to be staying around the 50% health range this entire fight so far. Every time he tries to heal up, they make sure that they keep him down in that danger range to where a quick burst might be able to bring him down before anybody can retaliate. Neffy being CC'd down at the bottom there.
Might not be a bad strategy to start keeping CC on him if you can't handle that BM.
Yeah, they're chain.
Take out their DPS so they can't kill you either, and hope you can get their mana down or energy down on the position.
Yeah, look, two squirrels on the battlefield right now, Neffy and Slow Shots. That allowed them to put a lot of pressure on Anticity.
Yep, that might be a strategy they're trying to switch to, is try to keep those other two guys CC so they can burst him down.
Yeah, Slow Shots and Neffy CC'd once again, with Anticity almost dying there. But luckily Slow Shots got out in time to heal him up.
Yeah, it's going to come down to who's better at managing DRs. You got the BM on one team and the C-Dom on the other team.
Are we going to see a follow-up CC,
nice
on
about, CC on the side?
And Ganked is CC'd at the
Ganked's
bottom.
Ganked's team seems to be hanging in a lot better this round. I think, it looks like Honor X switched back to Puri. Seems to be working out a little bit better for him.
And the split personalities is activated by Revert, so hopefully change around the little bit of tab targeting that might be happening. slow down the other team just a little bit, possibly. Anorxia in slow shots, keeping their distance and making sure the heals are flowing, which Ganked is putting a lot of pressure on Anticity right now. Neffy being CC'd once again. The Dom is not letting up on those CCs, that's for sure. Slow shot squirreled once
again. Slow shot squirreled once again.
I got Rebirth in the Mage Cage.
Yeah, the CCs are really flowing strong between these two teams. 5 minute warning. Neffy is asking about stealth. Yes, stealth is allowed, I believe. I did not see that in any of the
It looks like Neffy has switched out of BM. He might be running some, I don't know, Warlord Paragon or something like that.
We know that Paragon runs... We know that Paragon runs really well because Naked Stone utilizes Paragon very well in these competitions. Which, as everybody knows, they won the first godlike arena tournament with that build, with Cupcakey and Viral. So this match is definitely stretching along. The heals and everything are going really well. Everybody's trying to CC, but it's not seeming to pay off with anybody dying so far. But never know. It could change at any moment. Anticity got really low right then, but was able to CC Ganked right in time.
Oh, I almost had him.
That was a hell of a save.
Yeah, it was. Looks like they got some double pressure going on right there. One of those guys might eat it right here.
Anticity's very, very low, as well as Neffy, but it seems like they're going to recover. There we go. Neffy's almost back to full life now. Anticity is getting bursted down again, but able to heal right back up. Revert's getting some pressure as well, but it seems to not be, you know, fatal in any way. They're able to recover every time. Which is the reason why this match is going so long.
Two pretty good teams.
Yeah, the heals are really good.
Gank's taking some heat right now.
Yeah, but he's got that.
He's going to heal out of that, no problem.
He had that huge shield on him that stopped a lot of that pressure.
Looks like they're starting to go after the Dom again.
Neffy CC'd at the bottom there, and Revert in the split personality.
He's trying to get Revert.
But all the while the Anticity is chasing around Revert, Ganked is chasing around Anticity. So it's a bad DPS train going on right there, with somebody probably would go down if that kept going on very much longer. And people are yelling out that Physician is breaking the game. But is it?
Well, you know, just look at that energy bar on slow shots, you know?
But you know, anytime they release something new in any game, you get people saying stuff.
Yeah, that's true, but... I can't really speak from the PvE side, but from a PvP side, you know, with healers, you're used to just trying to get their mana down, drain it down. But it doesn't seem like a physician slash bard is going to have problems with their energy and spamming those heals.
This may possibly be our first stalemate. The 5-minute mark was called long ago, and I imagine it's close to being time limit.
Definitely a very good mat.
Yeah, Anorxie's spec right now is definitely keeping his team alive and well. He's running a Puri spec right now, so seems to be working out really well for keeping his team alive.
Yeah, he's running a Puri with a what is it? Ganked on position, I think. Where's Gameplay?
Intisti down to about 40% life, 30% range, something like that, but got healed all the way back up. So, yeah, nobody's dying. This is an interesting match. I think it's about to hit the stalemate mark any time now.
Looks like Ganked is running Sin.
Yeah. Which we know both teams have very good DPS, so with Neffy and Ganked really pouring on the pressure, but unfortunately, they are counting down to the stalemate right now. And it is officially a draw. Wow, our first stalemate. Which, that's the first stalemate that we've had at all. We didn't even have one during the first tournament, the entire thing. The heels were flowing too well, I guess. Which, there was a lot of CC, so it wasn't like there wasn't opportunities, but, you know, if they were able to break free at the right moments and everything, they really recover for their team, and nobody went down.
Well, that's an interesting call, because what do you classify C-Dom as? Because it's not really a healer.
Yeah, that's the thing that has been talked about quite a bit. So they've been basically debating what would classify a healer. How many points into a certain soul would classify you as a healer to be limited in these tournaments? So it's definitely up for discussion. I mean, I'm curious what everybody thinks about it. You know, not only the tournament organizers, but
yeah, it's a hybrid spec. I'm gonna have to go with the opinion that it's it's for low people encounters. So I couldn't say it's a heal spec.
Yeah, but where do you draw the line? You know, how many points in the chloro is it gonna take for you to be classified as a healer? That's something that's always up for discussion.
Well, C-Dom is more of a utility spec that has some survivability. You got to remember that a lot of the mage specs, they don't have any great defensive capabilities. So that's why you have specs like Charm and C-Dom. You got like a heal here, but I mean, we're talking about what? Bloom, Essence Surge are your only instant cast. And then you got Natural Healing, which is C-Dom. You still have to hard cast it, so. I'm gonna have to say that it's really, really a dueling spec. That's what it's considered. It's not considered a healing spec. Who goes into a warfront and heals on a C-Dom?
Some people in chat are saying if you can heal other players, then it should be considered a healing spec. Sounds like it's really being debated right now. The tournament organizers aren't sure exactly how to define one or the other. So, it's kind of...
These new classes have really thrown everything for a loop a little bit, really, haven't they?
Well, this spec that they're debating right now is one that's been around for a long time. You know, it's Chloromancer Dom spec.
Did they get it all figured out?
It sounds like it. They are calling for the teams to get ready, so I believe the decision was made that one dueling spec per team was okay. So the Chloromancer Dom spec is okay in their book. I guess that was the decision.
I think that's what they're going with. And you got to think that's the right call to make. I mean,
but the interesting,
if it's not a spec that's going to run top heals in the Warfront, then you really can't call it a healing spec, can you?
So the interesting thing is, and what the teams are asking right now, is should all three people on each team go DPS right now, since there was one draw?
That would be
definitely make the match shorter.
Okay, so they're saying 3 DPS with 1 dual spec allowed per team. So much to be considered there, because, you know, how many points?
I hope they give them some time to talk this out among themselves.
It's sounding like they're allowing them to. They're basically asking them, you know, just let us know when you're ready, so. Oh, it looks like this match is going underway. All right, they have been given the okay, and I'm assuming, what is it? Okay, they're going into stealth mode. That kind of confused me. I only seen 2 people charge in on each side. Wow, a lot of pressure being put on Neffy right now, which Ganked is not letting up on him, and Neffy goes down. Revert.
Looks like Revert's next to go down.
Yes. Wow, look at the damage being dished out. And, yeah, slow shots as well.
Oh, yeah, this is moving along. Very cool.
So we got Inorxy, Ganked, and Intisti, and of course it was a 2v1 at that point, and Intisti goes down. Ganked was running Riftstalker Sin Spec. So I'm being told that Hikos isn't playing right now, but why aren't we seeing more Shaman Specs is what I'm wondering. Because we've seen it do all right, so.
I'm back then. I missed it. Shit.
Yeah,
yes.
You missed it.
It was very fast. So that was a lot of DPS being poured out, and I guess all three sides, all three people on each side was DPS spec, except for they said one dual spec. So that's why the match ended so abruptly there. Yes, it is 2-2 right now. So yeah, we're going to the fifth match here. Wow, this is a really even matchup here.
Oh, so I guess if the match goes over 10 minutes, it's going to be everybody has to go DPS?
I'm assuming that's how it has to be, yeah. They said that one of the people on a team can be a dual spec, so... Not exactly sure what they are shooting for with that, but I'm sure both teams had it understood because they were ready to go on time. Which I'm assuming they mean dual spec as in a spec that can self-heal some. So,
you know, we might have to develop some type of rule book for common PvP tournaments on specs and their classifications and whatever.
Yes, that's the thing is there's so many gray areas, you know? I mean, how much healing in a soul can you go before you're considered a healer? I mean, who's to say that all three people on a team can't go a dueling spec and so that they have some kind of survivability? Well, of course you have one that's a healer, but what if the other two go a dueling spec? So, yeah, it's kind of interesting. You know, because in that kind of format, you'd have the matches always going to time limit.
I'll tell you what, I would definitely be breaking out a Char with Blade Mark in that situation. I think that would have the upper hand. Let's see, here we go.
All right, so I guess they are able to run healing specs again for this match. Because Ganked and Slow is both running Physician Spec. Slow Shots, of course, standing in his normal spot, which is over here to the right. He's staying behind the pillar just in case any kind of fire goes his way. Antisty is being squirreled, and Ganked is basically standing in the middle of the crowd for a moment there, but they're not seeming to focus on the two physicians any. But where was Neffy there?
Oh, Neffy just got squirreled. He was running all over the place.
Yeah, I was kind of—he just popped out of the side of the screen all of a sudden.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah. All right, slow shots still being not bothered, except for the squirreling that's happening. Ganked is free casting as well.
Yeah, they got him. Oh, there he goes.
All right, it looks like Neffy is running BM this time. So, yeah, the utility is in force.
Yeah, they're keeping him out of the game, that's for sure.
Well, they're doing as best they can. What's his name? He's taking some heat.
Yeah, Reverb.
I really don't like them messing with slow shots, that's for sure.
Yeah, slow shots has basically been back there healing away and not being bothered too much, because anytime somebody turns on him, they're definitely CCing as fast as they can to get any kind of pressure off of him. What is going on? Are they stuck again over there? Or
oh, we had a CC on the stairs again. At least on my screen.
Yeah, Neffy in the wall again?
Yeah, it looks like Neffy is stuck.
This is the never-ending match here. We've had so many glitches happen and so many restarts and a stalemate and then a 2v, two wins against two wins. Yeah, this is the match that never ends right here. They say this match has been going for over an hour now.
About Jim with us?
Well, I tell you what, if he was still here, me, Jenlar, and Cosmo would be beating all these fools. you know, he would have loved something like this. You know, he loved to have a good time, but I think he would have been real interested to do some type of Oracle spec in this type of thing, just because it was new.
Yeah.
He really liked to kind of sit down and theorycraft and try different things. You know, he really he's really into trying to figure out the most he could get out of something.
And the next
match was a good time. We went to my sister-in-law got married and spent about 5 nights in Boracay. I don't know if you're familiar with that. It's a sort of touristy beach vacation, but it's beautiful. And here they go again.
Yeah, this match is underway, and we're seeing the... Oh, they're dealing away with the pet right off the bat. So the BM life is not there. Yeah.
Anticity's got squirrel.
Looks like Ganked is using Physician once again, and Anorxia is running Inquisitor. So they're keeping swapping up, which is very, very cool. I wonder if it'll speed up the match or will it slow it down? You kind of got to wonder what kind of switches they're making in order to change the matchup here. Anorxie is CC'd and they're not liking the Inquisitor, that's for sure.
They're going to try and take Rebirth down.
Yeah, a lot of people
chasing their strategy has got to be to try and Maze Cage NRX and get that Dom out of the way first if they can. But they got to time it just right if they're going to be successful. Because it looks like Reverse is going to try and get some energy drained down on slow shots.
Yeah, Neffy's focusing on Ganked right now, but the CCs are hitting Neffy.
Focusing on Antisty, maybe.
Slow shot is in his slow normal shot. Spot. Which the Dom CCs are still pouring out right now. Neffy and slow shots are both getting squirreled repeatedly.
Yeah, Reaver's really focusing on trying to get Anticity's energy down.
Wow, both of them CC'd once again. The Dom is running rampant
also
on slow shots.
Also, those squirrels.
He's one of the best.
Yeah, he's doing an excellent job of keeping the CC's going.
And you get a guy like that or Racine or Medusa on your team, you're going to be pretty well taken care of with the CC.
Now,
when you get teams like this together, it really comes down to like CD management.
Yeah, since he's doing such a good job running Dom, you have to wonder when the other team is going to be drained and not going to be able to keep their heals up and stuff.
They Mace Cage Reverse, now they're going to try and take out INRX. Yeah, we need to get anybody.
Yeah, we got Neffy teeing off on Gank
like
down here.
Trying to get ganked.
Oh, what happened here?
Looks like we got somebody in the wall again.
Again? No, Anticity. No, the never-ending match. Oh my gosh. Another reset, sirs.
You know, we could probably limit running around on the stairs or something like that. Maybe make them all stand on that center thing. Limit how much they can run around.
Well, the thing is, it seems to be the fear bombs that are making people run into walls and stuff, so.
It'd be interesting if for when the death matches come in.
Alright, since this match has went on for so long, they have decided both teams must go full DPS.
It's like they're making everybody go full DPS.
So, this is going to be a quick match. Because we already know the DPS is pretty insane on both teams, so one of them is just going to floor the other before, you know, there's any retaliation. There's not going to be much kiting or anything going, it's just going to be death.
It's so weird because it doesn't happen all the time with you.
Alright, we are underway here. And it looks like Ganked is in Riftstalker Sin Spec again, so... Yeah.
Looks like Revert is our first casual.
Yep, and followed right behind.
Slow Shots is down too.
Yep. So that's one from each team. The match is alive and well right now. Ganked is focusing on Neffy, trying to get him down, whereas...
It's like Anticity is getting the next to drop.
Yeah, he's getting super low right now.
Anticity
super low
down.
Right now.
Oh! It's a battle.
Oh, damn.
Oh, Anticity's down.
And Ganked slipped away for a moment there, so.
Oh, that was good.
Wow, look at the low health all around, though.
Oh, no. Oh, it's just Neffy and INRX.
Yeah, 1v1, but Neffy is near death.
Tell you what, this makes for a fun match.
And the kiting begins.
I got him.
Yeah. Just need to get a CC in the slowdown.
Kind of wish we would have had more time to watch those guys fight, but you know that had been going on for a while. We needed to move on.
They say that match lasted 1 hour and 20 minutes.
Was that 1v1?
Yep, that was a Ganked INRX and Revert.
Oh, they're calling for the next team to come up. It will be Kawhi, which is... And I can never say this name right. Elsinskio? Or something like that. Which is running Warrior, Verity running Cleric, and Velvish running Cleric.
That's Verity, Velvish, and... what was it? Elson?
Yeah, that's what I was saying. I can never say that name right, so... and they will be going against Two Deeps, One Cup, which is Cupcakey running Cleric, Crumbonic running Rogue, and Naked Stone running Warrior. So that's the champions from the last tournament. We'll see how this one goes down. Which an interesting thing is both of these teams are running Warrior. You know, Warrior was a lot of times being speculated as not a class that was going to be included in these 3v3s, but we're seeing it being real productive, especially with the Paragon specs.
Yep, that and BM is a pretty good combination.
Which we haven't got to see too much of the Team Kawhi because this is the first tournament that they're in so far of these godlike arenas. So we don't know too much of what to expect except for what we've seen in the quarterfinals. So yeah, it's kind of a toss-up what's going to happen. We're not sure. The match is underway. And let's see, where's the focus going to be at? We see that Naked Stone is chasing around.
Swarming around the LOS there.
Yeah. Verity is getting a lot of use. Crumbonic and Naked Stone is all over Verity right now, and they're trying to keep him alive at all costs, but seems to be being burst down to 50% life pretty easily. But they are keeping him alive. Cupcakey is able to free cast and is running Sentinel spec right now. So the burst healing is really good on that side. Which we've seen her switch up with Defiler before, which has worked out really well in certain situations whenever the burst was just way too much. And it looks like Crumb is running Nightblade Sin spec.
Now, is there any reason to actually have the companion pets out? Is it something like a tab targeting thing?
Yeah, that's exactly what it's for. It forces people to be smarter.
Velvish.
I imagine a lot of these guys are running focus macros and stuff like that.
And down goes Velvish, so it is a handicapped team right now. Which Cupcakey has been keeping her team really well topped off, and it has annihilated the other team. Wow. That is pretty interesting. That was really good burst, but yeah. I mean, the healers did a good job there, but the burst from the Paragon Warrior and the Nightblade.
That was a very good match.
Yeah, Nightblade Sin just running rampant on people. The prediction, Cupcakey will not hit less than 90% health this entire tourney. That's an interesting prediction. And the next round is going here. Naked Stone charging right into Velvish. And let's see. Verity getting a lot of pressure put on him, but Velvish is going down to 50% health and getting healed up pretty well. It seems like Velvish is still getting... It's still Velvish and Verity both taking a lot of damage, both. So the DPS is being split up on Naked Stone and Cupcakey's team with Crumb there. They are not focusing on just one person this time. So Verity
is...
Yeah, it
looks like they're after Crumb Biotic now.
Yeah. Verity is getting a lot of pressure put onto him. He went down to almost 30% health at one moment there. But he's surviving all right with Naked Stone still chasing him around. And you can tell that the DPS is pretty high. Even whenever Naked Stone was chasing him solo and Verity goes down. Crumb is getting a decent amount of damage being put onto him, but it's not fatal in any way as Cupcakey seems to be keeping him alive. Oh, is Velvish going down? Yes, he does. And Crumb has been getting damaged a lot this entire match, but it seems to not cause too much of a problem for that team, I guess. They kept him at 50% health or above the entire time. So it's just the cleanup crew once again. Wow. So Two Deeps, One Cup has yet to lose one match in either tournament so far. And just a heads up, guys, the next match that is coming up after this one is going to be for the third place spot. This tournament, we are determining a third place winner. So there will be a match between the two other teams in order to determine the third place spot. And Verity, of course, getting pressured once again by Naked Stone. He has not let up on him. Naked Stone almost dies there. Went down to about 20% health for a moment there, but was able to be brought back up. And
some nice saves those healers are doing.
Oh yeah, the Velvish is putting on the pressure there. So Naked Stone sitting around the 40 to 30% health range this entire match almost. Verity looking like he needs to line of sight because he is getting a lot of DPS poured onto him. And Chrome take a lot of DPS going off altogether. Nobody's focusing one person, it seems. Everybody's taking some damage where it's not easy to keep up with heals. Chrome at about 20, 10% life right now. Is Chrome going down? Chrome is down. That is the first person to die on the two deeps, one cup. And he's been battle rezzed back, but he goes down immediately after. Wow, are we going to see the first loss for two deeps, one cup? Kawhi is really pulling this one out here. Verity is taking a lot of damage. He's around 50% health, but Naked Stone is in even worse trouble until that heal. So Verity's doing a line of sight, going ahead and getting his heals up. Naked Stone is chasing the person that I can't say their name. A lesson. I'll just say it that way. A lesson. Naked Stone still on a lesson. So the match has clearly slowed down a lot now since one of the major DPS has fallen off the race here. Looks like Verity is getting mana back there. Naked Stone, yes, Naked Stone goes down. We are witnessing the first loss of two deeps, one cup right now. It's a 3v1 match, and Cupcakey is about to go down, most likely. I don't think she'll be able to keep the heals.
There's gotta be a few people in the crowd thinking Cupcakey's gonna beat them all.
Yeah. The only hope that she could have is to stretch out the timer if she could survive three people hitting her at once, but I don't think that's going to happen. And Cupcakey is down. Yep. Wow. Very good match. Very, very good match. That was really exciting because we're not used to seeing that team in so much trouble. Like they've just really got us not thinking that would happen to them after all the success that they've had in the past matches. And that did shoot down the prediction of somebody that said that there would be, somebody predicted that there would be never a time that Cupcakey fell below 90% health. And it happened.
Yep. Now you gotta be wondering if maybe Cupcakey's team got a little too cocky, or maybe Velvet's team figured out something somebody else hasn't yet.
Very true.
Goes to show you, it really is anybody's game. I mean, these matches can go either way in a very quickly.
That's what I like about these new specs. It changes everything. You gotta think outside the box again, and that's what makes it exciting. Annoying.
Well, you know, I like to think that the onset of the PvP dimensions have really brought this sort of gameplay to interest for a lot of people. You know, there's a lot of people here that are traditionally thought of as good PvPers, but they didn't really get into that sort of mindset yet. So, you know, like Velvish, you know, that's somebody that's kind of up and coming in my mind that I recently met, and been very impressive what she has been doing.
Alright guys, since we have a moment of downtime while we're waiting on the 2-minute cooldown break, I have to give credit where credit is due for godlike awesomeness putting on this amazing tournament and setting up this amazing dimension. And almost all of the prizes were provided by them. So, yeah, there's so much credit to be given to these guys. They've done an excellent job, and they're putting on this event just for you guys. So I hope everybody appreciates it, because I really do. And yeah, everybody else that contributed toward the prizes, such as RG and Tryon and such, thank you very much.
I really appreciate the invite to oversee this. I've never seen the PvP dimensions in action, and this is just amazing.
Yeah, this is really cool. I mean, because you get to see a lot of the really good teams that, you know, are available right now, really put it on the line to, because there's a lot to be lost whenever you lose matches. I mean, you kind of, you feel the defeat, everybody gets to witness it, so it takes a lot of guts to put it on the line to go out there and...
Well, everybody in Rift takes their bragging rights pretty seriously.
Absolutely. So with these guys actually stepping up and taking part in a tournament like this, it shows a lot of guts, and it shows that they're willing to put it on the line. So that's really cool. And both teams have said that they are ready, and the go has been given.
I definitely hope to be invited back again to the next set of matches you guys do, and I will put up some loot and stuff for on behalf of the station.
That would
be
amazing.
We're going after Velvis this time around pretty hard.
Yeah, Velvis is really taking a lot of damage, and Crumb as well. So they're realizing what they need to do is, it seems like what they're doing
is... Oh, they got
a shield off on Crumb.
Yeah, they're really splitting up the damage, and it seems to be doing a really good job, because whenever Cupcakey can focus heal one person, like they're stacking the DPS on somebody, it seems that she does really well with dealing with that situation. So splitting up the damage is seeming to be key.
Cupcake's mana dangerously low right now.
Yeah, because she has to pour heals at her entire team rather than just focus healing one person. And yeah, it's really working out for
them. It's really working out for them.
Yeah, Phelps is out of mana. That's going to be a problem.
And, man, Crumb almost went down. He was at almost zero life whenever his health bar popped up. Velvis is almost going down himself. He was able to get the shield so he could get the heals going. And Cupcakey at 50% life herself. Wow, they're really putting a lot of pressure on the Crumb. They seem to see him as somebody that they could burst down fast enough without Cupcakey being able to retaliate, as long as they're keeping some pressure
on Cupcakey. They're doing a good job of keeping the pressure on both of them, and that's really going to tie up Cupcakey's resources to the point to where if they can keep it going, one of them's going to drop eventually, which is pretty much what's happening right now.
And is Crumb about to go down? Because he is line of sight in his own healer, not trying to, but that's what's happening.
He's down, but we lost Verity.
Yes, Verity goes down. Wow, we were thinking all the... Naked Stone goes down as well.
Be another one for the Bluebirds right there.
Wow. Yep. Cupcakey went Defiler for this one.
Yeah, he's about to be out of options here real quick.
What a good match. I mean, one person died on Kawhi's team to make you think that it could go either way, and in the end, they pulled it off against...
Tell you one thing. If you're Cupcakey's crew, you're coming into this thing thinking you got the advantage. After that match right there, you got to have a little sweat on your head wondering what's going to happen next round.
Absolutely. So that makes it 2-2 right now. Both teams have 2 wins. That was really cool.
I'm on Velvis's team.
Really cool to watch.
You got to be happy with the results so far. Taking 2 away from those guys is pretty good in anybody's book.
Because a lot of times you see in these matches where it's just almost kind of like a stalemate until one move gets off where the other one doesn't get to retaliate in time And, you know, it could take for a long time for that to happen. But, or else somebody gets mana drained or whatever else happens. And it's a long process a lot of times. Right now we're seeing just...
You know, sometimes a simple CC will, you know, people are running, you get LLS of a healer, and, you know, anything like that can be a game changer.
Yeah. Yeah, right now we're seeing just real active DPS and CCs going that are so fast that every single match is just...
Well, you know, I told you before this whole thing started, I think we might see some surprises out of Velvish and Verity's group over there with a guy's name that none of us can pronounce.
Yeah. So, I'm being told that Verity looks like he's running Oracle and Sentinel hybrid.
Yeah, that's an interesting spec to run.
And they're pulling it off.
Yeah, man.
That is pretty cool. Because, I mean, all of the opinions that I've been hearing is that people think that Oracle isn't that great in PvP right now. But... is Verity proving us wrong? So both sides have been given the okay and they are underway. Let's see where this go. This is a tied match now. All right. A lot of pressure being put on Naked Stone right now.
He's definitely one taking the heat right now.
Yeah, but he's not letting up on Verity. It's not stopping him from keeping the DPS going on Verity. Crumb also at 50%. They are really utilizing the same strategy again. You can see the entire two deeps, one cup team is pretty much floating around 50% life the entire time. So the
deep time might be it. Crumb's down.
Crumb is down.
Goes make is about done.
The same strategy is working.
Yeah. They're gonna get cupcakey right here.
Yep. So Naked Stone it almost went down there, and the 3v2 match, did she get Naked Stone up? Or it was Crumb that died.
Did she get Crumb?
No, he must be in the stands. Yep. He's out of the match completely. I was wondering if the B-res was going to happen. That's why I was asking.
I must have got that force respawn in time.
Yeah. Very interesting.
Definitely an underdog winner right there.
Wow. We just seen the defeat altogether of Two Cups, One Deep by Kawhi. The new team on this tournament format, and they are excelling. And they will be going to the finals.
Looks like there's some type of people complaining about the battle res is pointing them out. I think somebody just force responded before that happened.
Yeah.
And I can't think of a reason why a B-res would port you.
Well, the question is people are saying in chat as well that it was porting people out, so I wonder if anybody can test it out at least after the tournament and see if...
Is that happening on raising an opposite faction or the same faction? Anyone know?
Well, I mean, surely it would be the same faction.
I'm pretty sure they were forced respawn.
Yeah. But it's definitely something to test afterwards. You know, you never know when things can go wrong. Right. We're going to see two different teams in the playoffs here in the finals. But up next is going to be the match for the third place. But before then, let's go ahead and do a drawing for a Rex. You guys want that? Free stuff, cool stuff, and all of this is being provided by Godlike Awesomeness. So if you see any members of Godlike Awesomeness, specifically Aloe Gel or Kalia, give them a flying high five because they rock. And they are giving away all of this stuff in addition to running this amazing tournament. So make sure to leave some kind of You like my shirt? Like the shirt? Okay. Well, give some kind of comment in the comment section there in the chat so that you will be entered in for the drawing. And the rules are you have to be following my live stream. If you are not following the live stream and we draw your name, you are a loser, and it tells us if you're not following, so we get to poke fun and point at you and laugh and stuff. So let's get this going here. All right, you guys ready for this drawing? I'll give another 10 seconds before we do the drawing here. 10, 9, 8, 7. Is it a Charlie Brown shirt? You're saying my shirt's Charlie Brown? Man, that ain't cool. Alright. 3, 2, 1. And now they're making fun of my hairstyle. Guys, I'm trying to give you a Rex. Okay, drawing. Let's do it. Be sure you're leaving a comment. Leave a comment. Leave a comment. Okay, starting to give away. Bam! Evil Gummy Bear does not follow this channel. Such an awesome name. But it's a losing gummy bear this time. So
he won't be bouncing everywhere.
All right, so we will roll again, guys. We will roll again, because unfortunately, Evil Gummy Bear is not following my live stream.
Are they trying to test out the Battle Res bug?
Are they? I don't know. I figure, well, yeah.
It looks like it.
Yeah, they might be. So yeah, at least we'll get a. They're doing whatever they can to make right what some people are feeling is wrong. So that's really cool. I mean, you know, because I was thinking they would try this after the event was over. That way, you know, it doesn't interfere with anything, but they're getting.
Well, if they're going to do it now, let's hope they don't take a lot of time trying to figure it out. Sometimes you're just not going to find something that's not there.
Yeah, but the thing is whenever you're part of a team that you feel like your odds of winning were because of a bug, you know, you really feel cheated, you know, and that sucks. So, yeah, they're doing everything they can to try to solve the problem.
I can understand that. I just hope we don't take like 20 minutes testing that theory out.
Yeah. Well, he just beat Riz there.
Just kidding.
Well, I mean, I don't know about you guys. I'm on the East Coast, so, you know.
Yeah,
it's Saturday night.
Well, then, I mean, they need to fucking hurry up with this shit. That's all I'm saying. Let's get back to the fucking fighting.
Oh, we're rolling again, guys. So, let's do this roll once again. I'm sure all of you have left comments in the comment section and are all following my live stream, right? How many people do we have in?
That name. Epic.
Okay, here, we're rolling again. Whoever wins this wins a Rex. And the winner is... Yoked Real does not follow this channel.
Yoke does not follow. There's so you need to come back to Riff, Yoke. Come back to Riff.
Nah, he's not playing anyway.
Alright. We will roll once again, guys. We will roll once again. All right. I don't think the third place match is going just yet. No. Okay. So leave a comment in the comment section and let's go ahead and He's yelling at me, I am following. I am following. You wasn't at the time of the drawing, unfortunately. I'm sorry. Alright, so... here we go. We will roll once again. Make sure you're following, guys. Bam. The next roll is... Tyos currently follows this channel. Alright, Tyos, we finally get a winner. Cool, cool, cool. So, we will go ahead and write this name down because this person... Okay, there's a second requirement. We're putting a second requirement onto this. If you win and you're following this channel, you have to reply to me within 30 seconds. If you are not watching my live stream right now, you do not win. He replied. Okay, you're a winner, man. You are a winner. I hope the delay on the live stream doesn't upset you, but yeah, that's an extra requirement now. So, the third place game is underway, and I do have your name wrote down, Tyus, and I will message you on Twitch either tonight or tomorrow morning. Probably tomorrow morning. So, all right.
This is for third place. All right.
Yes. We've got...
This is going to be interesting. You got Slow Shots team that's running the physician as a healer versus Cupcakes team.
Mm-hmm. So, let's go ahead and list off these competitors. I'm sure you've heard them all before, but this is the third place game and is Team Slow Shots, which is a rogue, Antisti, the warrior, and Neffy, the warrior, against Two Deeps, One Cup, which is Cupcakey, a cleric, Crumbonic, which is a rogue, and Naked Stone, the warrior. So, yeah, we're about to be underway.
Well, I don't know if you remember, but, you know, Neffy and Annie Slowshot over there is a team that gave Gangster Crew such a hard time, the one that we were watching for like an hour and a half.
Mm-hmm.
So this might be a very interesting match, too, these two teams against each other.
Yep, we're going to get to see what goes down. I cannot wait. And guys, don't leave. We're doing more drawings. Yes, they did lose, and it is single elimination. However, we do determine a third place team, so they do have to play against each other. Looks like Cupcakey is back on Sentinel spec.
It's underway.
Yes, indeed. Let's
see. I haven't seen much change. Uh-oh. Antisti's about to drop.
Yeah, Crumb is getting a lot of damage as well, though. It seems that these teams are realizing that they need to focus on Crumb because it seems like he's getting burst down a little bit more than everybody else, so they're focusing him quite a bit. But Neffy and Antisti are seeming to take a lot of damage right now. Antisti is almost going down. He's sitting at about 20% life.
Low.
And is he going? He goes down. Wow. What a fast match. But it's not over. Yes, he's back up.
Oh, they got Annie back up.
Yes. But he goes right back down. Lack of buffs will do that. And Neffy's low right now and seeming like he's about to go down as well.
Yeah, Slow Shots is way on the other side of the world.
Yeah, Slow Shots and Cupcakey are basically just standing beside each other watching the match unfold because there isn't too much more you can do once your teammate dies and you do not have the opposing team low at that moment. So, yeah.
Wow.
1-0. Two deeps, one cup.
That was a good cup.
My hair did not attack you through the screen. No, it didn't.
Well, going home with something is definitely better than going home with nothing, so. 2-minute break.
Grimm's toupee. Yes, sir. Thing is, if I wear a hat all the time, everybody thinks I'm bald. It's not cool. I get the, what's the YouTuber's name that, always has the bald look going? Man, I can't remember the guy's name for some reason right off the bat. Can't remember it. I'd remember it any other time, but. The Walkie, yeah, that's what he is. That's his name. Awesome YouTuber. You're not bald, you're beautiful. Now give me a Rex. Now that's the kind of stuff that I want to see whenever I look over. I don't want to see trolling. I want to see bald is beautiful, bro. Don't be ashamed. Oh, you guys are hilarious sometimes. Clearly total biscuit. Oh, now I got people sending me tales saying my hair is OP. Alright, looks like the second round.
Trying to sweet talk you out of that Rex.
Oh, yeah. If I could give everybody a Rex, I could, but they don't give me enough. It's all provided by godlike awesomeness. They only give me a certain amount to give away. So, Slow Shots team is signaling that they are ready. We have to wait on Cupcakey, Naked Stone, and Crumb to be ready.
Looks like we're off second round here.
I didn't ban anybody, so I'm not responsible. Anticity is already being focused very, very deep, very, very hard. It's
very, very hard.
So I wonder if the strategies are being changed up very much on each team. I mean, surely they're adapting to the situation, but you see that...
Well, I'm sure people who aren't, in the arena at the moment are closely watching the other team trying to figure out what their best strategy is going to be.
Yeah. But it seems like the same strategy is being put into place here, where Anticity is being focused really hard again.
Well, you know, Cupcake's team, they got the experience to know what the best strategy is from the get-go.
Yeah, it worked certainly last
worked
time.
Last time
it worked last time.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's looking like Anticity's going down.
He's putting up a fight, but he goes down.
Yes. Slow Shots. Being focused some now, but Neffy getting a lot more damage than anybody right now. It's... looking really bad for him. I don't think Slow Shots is going to be able to keep him alive. Oh, he gets him to full health. Look at that. But it is a 3v2 match, so yeah, it might spell doom.
Yeah,
for
he
him.
Might.
No, they definitely would need a miracle right now.
Yeah. Well, the one good thing is that Slow Shots doesn't have to heal anybody except for Neffy, so he's able to keep him alive a little bit longer.
Kind of wondering why Neffy isn't running BM.
Yeah, he's been running that most of the time, I think, so... Can you see...
Might be one of the few things that could probably get Cupcakey.
Mm-hmm.
I'm holding out pretty well, just the two of them.
Yeah. The problem is that they're not doing, you know, they're not getting the other team down at all, so it's just a waiting game, it's looking like.
Yeah. They're eventually young. I don't think they're going to pull this out.
Yeah.
Not unless somebody DCs.
Just a matter of when Slow Shots is going to run out of mana, because he's seeming to keep Neffy alive. Or energy, should I say.
kind of wondering why they're not switching targets to slow shot.
Yeah.
Trying to interrupt him or something to that effect.
Well, I don't think they're too much worried about it is the situation now. They kind of know they've got it in the bag, and they're not too worried about, you know, trying to do too much complicated stuff. They're not even switching over to CC or interrupt. It didn't seem like
anyone.
I'll tell
you one thing, though. Physician is definitely looking very impressive for PvP. Makes me a little bit jealous.
So it's 2-0 right now. 2 minute break, 2 minute cooldown break. So we're seeing two deeps, one cup, kind of going back to their winning ways here. Unfortunately, they're out of the running to get into first place, though. So,
all right. There we go. This might be the last chance for the birds in blue.
Definitely. Oh, slow shots. Wow, look at the DPS that went on him immediately. And Naked Stone is really low as well. Man, they're really putting it to slow shots. He's pretty much been untouched for the most part in all of the matches. He's the one that's always been able to stand back and heal away, but they're not letting up on him now. They're swapping it up, and you almost kind of wonder why, because they were winning just fine with their current strategy.
Naked's taking some heat too.
But it may win them the match again. Who knows? Even with the new strategy. Crumb at around 80% health now with a shield on, so he doesn't have too much to worry about anymore. But Naked Stone charging in. Oh, look at slow shots. He is dangerously low right now. And Crumb goes down. Wow. So two people were right about to die, and Crumb was the one that dropped. But the battle res has got him back up, so no force respawn going on there, and no bugs happening. Anticity taking a lot of damage, but seeming that he's doing what I like to call the juke, is whenever you run away from somebody, and then you turn around and run right back into him, and it slows them down on DPS and you a little bit. But he's still getting focus fired a lot. But Naked Stone goes down. A double kill. Look at that.
That's a first all night.
Yeah, but Anticity got brought back up since they had their battle res still ready to go.
The yellow team's only got two dogs in this fight now.
So Neffy's putting
might
a lot
be going
of
going into extra innings. One.
Look at Crumb using the slip away. But he is dangerously low right now. Cupcakey is trying to keep him alive, but they focus target back onto Cupcakey right now. Which.
He's just running out of mana. He can only hold out for so long.
Yep. Yeah, they're putting a lot of pressure on her, and she seems to be kiting just fine. She seems to be a step ahead of the DPS, so. But, wow. They caught up with her, and they're putting it to it. Yeah, down goes Cupcakey. We've got a match on our hands, guys. And Crumb is about to be finished up. It is just a matter of cleaning up the last person. Oh, they're laughing at him. They're toying with him. Trollage in the arena. All right, we've got a match. It's not a sweep. It was looking like it was going to be a sweep.
Looks like they're running some kind of Warlord Paragon over there on the blue team.
You think with Neffy? Or
they definitely came back with a vengeance.
Or Anticity.
Well, you know, you gotta be glad that you were able to get at least one out of this, so you have a little respect for yourself. But I think Cupcake's team is still the team to beat, but you know, might be a little bit more swell on their brow this next match.
Yeah, that's I like these matches that it's up in the air. You don't know which team is going to win. Whenever you have one side just really, you know, winning every match and it doesn't seem to be there in any real danger, you know, you don't really sweat it and you don't get too much into it. But whenever you got matches like this that either side could drop at any time.
Well, call whatever you will. It's definitely on their mind right now.
Yep.
I think good thing I noticed about this tournament is you had a lot of people that people already knew, but there was also some, I guess you could say, up-and-coming future stars of the PvP up in here, too. Like, you know, when we first started, I thought we might see something out of Elvis's team, so I was pretty happy to see them progress the way they did.
Yeah, a lot of people that you might not see normally, like you're pointing out, now we're getting to see them shine, which is pretty cool. Getting to see a lot of faces that may not be names just yet, and they're becoming names in this tournament.
Looks like they're about to get underway here. Looks like they're going to be putting Brother-in-Arms up on Crumb, trying to keep him up and getting down. That's a smart move.
And this match is underway once again, and we're seeing some focus on Neffy this time. Which, did Neffy change to a healing spec? Whoa, Naked Stone is getting dangerously
low. Oh, Naked
is
in trouble. I don't know how the hell he survived that one. I guess when you have Cupcakey on your team, magical things happen.
Yeah, the healing on that team is pretty insane most of the time. So, yeah, there seems to be a lot of focus being
this
done.
This turned out to be a pretty interesting match.
Yeah, but Naked Stone is definitely getting the brunt of the damage, along with Neffy. Neffy is getting focused a lot as well.
I think it's going to come down to the question of Cupcakey's mana management, and that's running pretty low right now.
You're getting to see.
For a second there, they were going for a double kill.
Yeah, what they're doing is they're really forcing Cupcakey to use all of her mana. By focusing two targets instead of one, she has to keep casting more stuff. She's running out. Eventually, she'll wear them down and get one of them. It's a good strategy.
Which, as you can see, Slow Shots is way away from the fight as usual and staying away from the harm.
Yeah, they can't even afford to pay any attention. That, you know, they're trying so hard to get the, what's his name down? Neffy. Looks like Neffy's running a really hard time for them.
Yeah. Which, still a lot of damage being put on the Naked Stone, and he is so close to death.
Cupcakey is running out of stuff to keep him up. One of those guys is getting dropped pretty soon. She's really out of mana now.
And the strategy by Slow Shots over there is... Oh, man. Did Naked Stone just go down? Yes.
Now comes Crumb or Cupcake, one or the other. Oh, they got the B-res off.
They did, but the buff's got to be put up before he goes straight back to death. Yeah, look, he's just taking so much damage. Yeah, whenever you don't have the buffs.
Yeah, whenever you don't.
But we kind of seen a different type of strategy by Naked Stone there, because so much damage was being dished out at him. It seemed like he was doing a bit of kiting instead of just straight DPS the entire time. Seen him retreat several times.
That's the nice thing about position is, you know, if you're traditional here, you're going to have to worry more about your having to stand still to cast at times, and then also your mana management. Doesn't seem like the position has either of those problems.
Yeah, two wins to two wins. We definitely have a match on our hands. So, yeah, what I was saying about Slow Shots is you notice that he keeps way away from the fight. So if anybody even thought about going to deal with him, they've got to go all the way away from the rest of their team. And you know, you're breaking away from all the combat, you know, and you're going over there to focus on a healer that's staying away from everybody else. So, yeah, his strategy's working pretty good.
Yeah, that can definitely be a factor.
You have to do the whole UI thing, Grim, where you can make import your UI as completely broken. So
Well, here we're off to the tiebreaker.
Yeah, we'll have to work on that next time. Because it's
You're
definitely
trying to get
not.
slow shot down.
It's definitely not working right now, so. But yeah, let's see here. Slow Shots is not able to pull away like he has in the past. Naked Stone is making sure to pull him in and apply lots of DPS. As you can see, Slow Shots is trying to get his distance, though, but he keeps getting pulled in. So he's not able to do the same strategy as he has been.
Yeah, that might be an effort in futility there. I don't know how successful that composition is going to take down a position. It's really about the position you got to get after their energy. And his bar doesn't seem to be hurting too badly.
Yeah, it's looking like they're running Bard with Crumb. Interesting choice of class here. Crumb is running a bard and Cupcakey is on Sentinel Hills right now, so that's
That looks like they're targeting Naked again.
yeah, a lot of focus being put on Naked. It's obviously helped them out a lot in these last two matches, putting a lot of pressure on him, so I guess they're thinking to recreate that same situation that has been working for the last two matches.
Yeah, I think it's going to again come down to Cupcakey's mana management. That's going to be what it's going to get their team into trouble.
But it seems like nobody's getting low on health right now, except for the focus being put on to Naked Stone. But everybody seems to be healing up just fine so far.
Hopping close to those stairs, man, making me nervous like they're going to get glitched again.
Well, Slow
Oh
Shots
yeah,
has
let's hope so.
CC'd
Slow Shots at the same.
Yeah, with Slow Shots being CC'd like that, they were able to burst Neffy down quite a bit, but once he got out of CC, he was
Oh,
able
they
to heal him back
got
up.
him again.
Yeah, he CC'd once again, so Neffy's taking a lot of damage. Oh, and I was thinking for a moment there that Neffy was going to be line of sighted from slow shots whenever he got out of CC, but he got to him just in time.
I think he threw biofeedback on him right there.
Look at the pressure being put on the Naked Stone. Is he going to? Yeah, he's starting to try to jump away to get a little bit of the pressure off of him. He almost went down there.
Some amazing heals going on.
Neffy goes
Neffy's
down.
down.
Neffy go
And he's B-rezzed up.
And he's back
Neffy's
up.
back
He's
up.
back up.
Yep. Interesting match. Wow, this is so back and forth.
Yeah, Cupcakey's getting low on mana. Looks like she's trying to do a better job of keeping it up this round, though. She must realize that's her weak point.
Yeah, but the thing is that if Crumb is running Bard, he can keep that mana up.
Yeah, but they lose out on the DPS, and while she's trying to keep her mana up, they're going to be a little bit weaker to burst.
Yeah, but that might have been their
They're
weak
really
point.
getting on
That might have
heavy.
been their weak.
Their weak point these last two matches may have been the mana management, so.
Oh, that's definitely what the weak point was.
Yep. So if they corrected that, they may be in a better situation, even with the lack of the burst DPS that they might be suffering from. Neffy goes down for the
Neffy,
second
go.
time. Wow. Okay. So there won't be another B res go up there, so. And Slow Shots have been CC'd that entire time almost after Nephew went down, so.
That's nothing to be ashamed of. That was a That was a pretty good match right there.
Yeah, that was a very good match.
I don't know if I'd be talking shit if I was Grum. You guys almost lost that one.
Yeah. Just some post-fight trash talking. They knew they were on the line. It was two wins.
They were definitely sweating it, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah. It's almost like a joking.
Another demonstration of how overpowered physician is.
Yeah.
Ring around the rosy. Pocket full of posy. Physician. Nobody falls down.
Oh, no. He's going down. And he's not.
And will we be seeing another stalemate? Well, he goes down. We've got our third place winners here.
Good job, Cupcakey's team.
Yes, very, very cool.
Yes, Cole team.
I believe that is the match. We have our third place winners. Very cool. Well deserving, and that was a heck of a match between those two teams. Very evenly matched. So our finals match is Kawhi, which is El Cincio, which is running Warrior, Verity, which is Cleric, and Velvish, which is running Cleric, against 1v1 owned, which is Ganked running Rogue, and Norxie running Cleric, and Revert running Mage. So, should be an interesting match. Both sides are getting ready to go, and this one is the best of seven, so yeah, one team has to win four matches here.
Here we go.
And the match is underway. Alright, let's get lined up here. Let's see.
Looks like Rebirth's going to be focusing on Verity to start with.
Yeah, I'm being told that Inorxie is running Defiler for this, and Gank looks like 61 Marksman. So definitely a change of pace here. Going for the chain silences.
Reaver's definitely running C-Dom.
Yeah, Ganked is definitely trying to put a lot of pressure on the Verity and keep the silences rolling. Which is also an awesome spectrum debuff. And Gank jumping around like a pogo stick right now. Yes, indeed. The Eradicate will be running rampant with the Marksman spec there. So the debuffs are going to be going like crazy, as well as the silences. So you'll probably see these guys really running low on buffs and having to rebuff themselves quite often. Velvish is being squirreled right now, so Revert is doing his thing, definitely.
Oh, the trick here for Gank's team is going to be to, how do they get both Verity and Velvish's mana down at the same time so they can kill one of them?
Yeah, Velvish is really trying to chase Ganked around so that he can put more pressure on, you know, the person that's really causing so many problems to their healer. So, yeah, this is an interesting match, to say the least. And Norxie was getting CC pretty good there. Yeah, Revert's teeing off as much as he can, but he is getting hit quite often, though. He's doing a good job of trying to jump away and CC him as he's going, though. Revert taking a lot of damage. Velvish is really putting it to him right now, but of course the reaction is that he gets squirreled. He's going to slow down that damage every opportunity that he gets. Ganked is still putting a lot of pressure to Verity. I guarantee the silences are happening every 15 seconds there. They're still trying to put quite a bit of damage on to Gank to try to get him to not be able to focus on Verity so much, where he's got to keep mobile and can't just chase Verity around. And Orxie, and Orxie's seeming to be able to cast Free Will right now. They're not really focusing him too much, so the Defiler heals are going really strong. And you better believe
he might be in some trouble.
Yeah, you better believe it. If they start to get low, he can pop ugly and have them go invincible pretty much for 10 seconds or so.
Yeah, they're not going to get anywhere until they get that pop, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Could we possibly have another draw on our hands?
Possibly.
It's definitely looking like it's leading that way.
Oh, that would be kind of rough, because this is the best of seven if these guys are fighting the draws.
I think no matter what the outcome of this round, we can expect some changes to be made on both sides.
Oh, yeah.
I know all of these players are very versatile with their specs. They can do different things.
Yeah, they've been swapping it up quite often and running different specs almost every single match they're swapping it up. So they're definitely keeping everybody guessing, and they've got to readjust their targets at all times. Yeah, I'm being told that Ganked is missing almost all of his buffs right now. They're stripping his buffs like crazy right now. That's going to take away a lot.
Yeah, they'd definitely be good at debuffing on that side.
Yeah, that's going to take away a lot of his flair altogether. He's not going to be able to put the pressure on like he wants to. Yeah, Dom running rampant right now. Look at it. Free casting on to the enemies at will. Is he going to get focused some now?
It's definitely going to come down to mana.
Yeah, this is becoming a drawn out match.
Maybe he's starting to get low, but he might have a pot or something available.
Yeah, but how much is the Dom going to be playing part in that? You know,
it's times like these that you love having your consumables off the cooldown.
Verity's getting very low right now. And Revert is making sure to apply the pressure to Verity right now. And he squirreled a Lynx right down.
Verity's out of mana.
Uh-oh. That's not good.
Looked like he was trying to line of sight and it didn't work.
Yeah, he's trying to get back there and cast his mana regeneration right now.
Yeah, he was successful.
Yeah, he got a pretty long cast going there. Didn't get bothered one bit, which made it really nice for him. And the 5-minute warning has been given. So these guys have been doing battle for 5 minutes already.
And it looks like we got the 5-minute warning.
Yeah, commentary in the chat, they're saying that if you get rid of the heals, then it's a free win for Ganked and team. So, I don't know. Maybe. We'll have to see.
I guess it all comes down to your choosing who you decide to bring with you. You know, you can't fault people for the compositions they brought to the table.
Absolutely. People are saying in chat that they're tired. Oh man, how can you be tired with this kind of excitement? Although this match is being drawn out, but the rest of the night, most of it has been pretty fast matches, so.
Just, there were some really good battles tonight, you know, some surprising outcomes.
Yeah. A lot of unexpected matches, too. I mean, you didn't expect some people to win when they did, and whenever they did, it seemed to really expose a weakness in the other team.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with Velvet's group, you know. I don't think many people had pegged them to go this far into the match, to the tournament.
Yeah, the pressure seems to be still being put on to Verity, but I don't know. He's sitting around 50% health with Gank chasing him around, but it seems like he's getting enough mana to still keep himself alive. So, yeah.
As long as he doesn't make some sort of fatal error, he's not going to go down.
And you notice he's not chain casting. He's kind of running some and then cast, and then, you know, it's a little bit of mana conservation.
He's trying to use that LOS to his advantage to kind of give him some breathing room to cast that mana regeneration.
Absolutely.
You know, disconnected from the DPS on the other side.
And he's also getting the mana regeneration spells off, too. You can see him light up blue, which is him mana regenerating. And he's done it several times now, and each time he doesn't get bothered until he's got quite a bit of it done.
Yeah, it looks like Velvis' team is running Oracle Scent and some sort of BKB now. So that's going to be a lot of support, CC, so you know they might not have the amount of DPS to take anybody down on the other side as well, too. So looks like both sides are going to have to go back and rethink what they're going to do the next round. So this is definitely looking like it's going to be a stalemate.
Yeah, this next round is going to be a DPS fest because the one-minute warning has been given. Now, I'm not too sure if these guys are going to be able to put the nail in the coffin on the other side before that 1 minute is up. A lot of stuff going on, but, you know, not too much damage seems to be dished out now. I imagine the energy's pretty much running low on a lot of these guys now.
Yeah, they should all just head back to their spawn points at this point. There's got to be like 20 seconds left.
Verity's definitely using that pillar to his advantage. He's been circling that thing all match and been doing it all night. He's been putting it to very good use of line of sight.
Yeah, they might be in trouble now. It's been called a stalemate and one healer now.
Yep.
So that's definitely going to mess with their ability to put different comps on the table because two of them are cleric.
And we have a draw, guys. One healer per team now, as Landslide already pointed out.
Well, looks like they're saying each team already had one healer, so looks like everybody's going DPS.
Wow. Yes, Aloe Gel has said everyone is to go DPS.
It'll be interesting to see how it goes with them all being DPS.
Yeah, some of the people were thinking that 1v1 owned would have the advantage whenever going full DPS, but we're about to see. We're going to see if the Kawhi team can pull it off. Which, Kawhi is running Warrior and two Clerics, so they're going all DPS. Are we going to see Inquisitor? Are we going to see a Shaman? What are we going to see, I wonder? Unfortunately, it does have to go all DPS. I know that some of the people don't like that the teams have to go all DPS, but whenever it's gone to draws and stuff, you've kind of got to have a winner of some way. So, I know, nobody enjoys making everybody go DPS. They would rather just everybody run the spec that they're normally running, but if we didn't do this, I mean, we've already done this with several matches, and still we had a matchup that went an hour and 20 minutes. So yeah, if we wasn't making these guys go all DPS sometimes whenever a stalemate happens, we'd be in for a heck of a long night. All right, the decision has been made. They said we are going one more normal game, then everyone go DPS if it's a draw.
So it looks like one more normal match with a 10-minute time on it?
It's looking that way. Oh, they're asking. Oh, that's Landslide saying that. Okay, I thought somebody else was saying that. But it's looking like it might be a 10-minute timer. As you can see, a lot of things have to be innovated as we go along because, you know, time constraints and everything kind of makes it rough. I was saying if a match goes the 10-minute distance, should the next round be a normal match again but with a 5-minute timer every time?
I think we should just start with the 5 minutes. You know, make these tourneys go a lot faster. That's one of the biggest turnoffs to them is just how long it takes.
So the go has been signaled and we are going into a normal match here. I believe it's still the 10-minute limit, so this may be another stalemate if it goes that way again.
I'm going after Reaver pretty hard.
Yeah, but the pressure is also being put to Verity again. I wish I could say
I wish I could say that guy's
name. I just can never pronounce his name, so I can't commentate it. All right. Ganked is receiving a good amount of damage, but he seems to be getting away from it. It seems like the damage is really being spread out. As you can see, four different people are near 50% health at that moment. So no focus is just being on one guy on each team. But Verity is definitely
Yeah, they got two of them down.
Yeah, look at the... Look, Verity's trying to regenerate mana every chance he gets. And Velvish is being squirreled. Revert is definitely keeping the CCs going very nicely. Revert.
Looks like Ganks is getting the double tank poison and revert mana drain killing on.
Down goes revert.
Oh no! Looks like Alcina might be down too.
Yeah. Man, Verity was just mana drain the entire time. You could see him always going to try to regenerate his mana, but it just wasn't getting enough. I mean, obviously Ganked was running some debilitating poison, and you know, with the Dom mana drains and everything else, it's just
yeah. He had debilitating poison and revert mana drain, so he ganked his ass.
Yeah, that was pretty interesting. Lots of mana draining going on. All right, the go signal has been given, so we are going to match number two here. And Velvish is already putting the pressure onto the Dom. Revert is getting lots of punishment right now.
I went to Fairy. That's going to be a little bit of a setback for the blue team.
Oh man, look at this damage going out. Okay, there has definitely been a change-up. Velvish looks like he's running Shaman Spec right now. So, we're finally seeing the Shaman running wild in the Warfront. Well, it's not a Warfront, it's a tournament. Why should I say Warfront? Too used to YouTube videos running Warfronts. Verity is trying to put the pillar to good use and trying to line of sight once again. You can see Ganked is not letting up on him. It's obvious the mana is...
Ganked staying right on him.
Yeah, mana is being drained like crazy right now. And you can see Revert chasing him around. Yeah, Ganked is applying the pressure to Verity, and you can see Revert chasing around as well, so you know exactly that the mana... Mana draining is going crazy right now. And I'm getting word the Lynx XO, I guess that's how we'll pronounce it, is still running Void Knight BM. So, yeah, BM pet purging ganked every time it hits. Interesting stuff.
I don't know how they intend to really kill anybody with that spec, but, you know.
Yeah, but it's an interesting change up there.
And yeah, Anorxie, strategy.
Yeah, Anorxie is running Puri right now.
Definitely look like Gank's team has a little bit more of a handle on the fight. You know, it seems to be swinging their way more than the other way for Belvish and Verity's crew.
Yeah, Ganked is almost dead.
What did I miss? Well,
and he managed to get back up. He was almost dead there. Anorxie is keeping the heals going. But Verity is still being the focus. That is definitely the person that is getting all the heals.
He's going to start getting real sticky.
Yeah. This entire match here has been the story of how much pressure Verity can withstand without going out of mana and dying. Revert is getting a lot of pressure put on him now, so. But Anorxie is keeping the heals going, so.
Yeah, Belvish is putting the hurt in.
Yeah, Anorxie's doing very good.
See that guy on my cat.
Very good heals.
I don't think I've seen Ganked let up on Verity 1 second of this match yet. Anytime that he's not hitting him, it's because he's CC'd, because he is making sure to stay on him at all cost right now.
Yeah, he's getting a little bit of trouble from Elsino Man over there.
So Verity at half health, but able to get back to almost full health for a moment there, but it's not letting up on him. Revert is making sure to keep the pressure as well as Ganked. So you know the poison's flowing right now, but Anorxie is keeping all of his team healed up really well as well.
Verity's running low on MP, so that's going to spell danger for their team. Really, really low. That might be it for Verity right there. I don't see him coming back from this.
Yeah, you can see he's trying to reach it.
He's trying to reach it.
BM'd on Ganked. Oh.
Verity.
Yeah, that's a tough guy, isn't it? They got him right there.
Yeah.
Verity's down.
You knew it was a bad situation whenever he was trying to mana regenerate right while he was getting hit. You knew he was just out of mana. He was doing whatever he could.
They got smile on Elsino Man. They're going to go right after Belvish. Elsino can't do nothing but watch. They're just gonna ignore him.
It's looking like Anorxie is... He put some points into Druid. He's got Oak Shield up. So, Puri, Druid. We're seeing a lot of interesting specs in these matches.
Well, you don't want to underestimate that fairy. You know, I was wondering when somebody was going to go after that.
Absolutely. 2-0 so far. Wow. So 1v1 owned is starting to shine through, much like a lot of people thought they would. So, yeah, this is really cool to watch, I'll tell you that. And the pressure is definitely on Belvish and team, because now they're down 2, but it is the best of 7, so they have to lose 2 more matches in order to be put out of this. That's a lot of opportunity to make a comeback.
Well, if they're going to be ballsy and try something, they might want to consider it this match to see how it works.
Let's see if the team Kawhi can deal with the pressure. Because whenever you're down two and you know that the other team kind of has your number at the moment, you have to realize that there's a lot of pressure on you. And you might perform even worse once the pressure is on you. So
they've got to be getting tired at this point.
Oh, yeah. Definitely all the stuff that they're doing is... Yeah, the fatigue is definitely setting in on these teams, you know. I mean, they're under the pressure anyway. So going all the way to the finals and performing at this level, it's rough.
Here we go.
Oh, it looks like, oh, Encino Man, as you call him, has changed from VK Spec into Warlord Tempest. So we're going to see an actual Warlord Tempest.
Looks like they're going after Reaver.
So this is pretty much the first time in these the godlike arena that we've seen anybody run Warlord primarily on their skill set. Everybody usually goes either.
Yeah, Warlord's really underestimated, in my opinion. There's a lot of cool things that that he can do in PvP.
Yeah, it's always been really good in the like a Warfront situation, but in 3v3, it's always been kind of doubted all the time. So, yeah.
I don't know. I wouldn't claim to be an expert at Warrior, though.
So,
yeah,
and Verity is getting super low as well. Oh, already going into the mana regeneration. So, I highly doubt he's out of mana right now, but you never know. I imagine what he's trying to do is prevent the situation where he does run out of mana. So,
well, the thing you gotta be looking at is they got two guys on the shit right now, so one of them's gonna drop. Because that man is low.
Verity is down.
There goes Verity. Oh, we're going to get a two.
Oh, man. Well, it's looking pretty bad.
Yeah, it's only a
pretty bad
amount of time for Velvish.
Yeah. Kawhi is going down here. So it's looking like a 3-0 win so far for this team. So they only need one more match in the books for them to be declared winners.
Might have a shutout here, folks.
Yeah, that would be interesting for it to go 4-0 in the finals. Because you know both teams were good enough to make it here. It'd be kind of odd for it to be a sweep at this point. And for the next one, we will hopefully fix this UI thing. I want to hide the UI for you guys, but look what happens. Bam. No health bars. No health bars. Uh-oh, I might have broke it. Okay, there we go. Man, that almost went bad. But yes, we will try to fix that next time. That would have been a catastrophe if I would have broke the health bars right there. So, they're asking if each other are ready now. And the countdown begins. 2-1, and the go has been signaled. Both teams are entering the match now.
Here we go.
Right off the bat, Velvish squirreled, so the CCs are going pretty heavy. Looks like we got a BM comp over there. Revert has already went into split personalities, and looks like the pressure is once again on Verity. They realize the strength is definitely into draining Verity's mana. And Ganked is all over Verity as well. And you can see Revert moving around the pillar just like the other three matches.
He does seem to be their focus.
Yeah, and Orxie is doing a decent job of healing, but there isn't too much healing to be done, really, because Verity is...
He's about to drop right here.
Wow, this could be a very fast match. What a good move there. They pulled the pressure off of Verity for a moment there. The pulls were real, sirs. And Verity is down. Velvish is CC'd as well, so... Yeah, it's looking like we're going to see a 1v1 owned sweep in the finals.
It's definitely looking like that. Did they get that? No.
Well, the interesting thing is that I'm being told that Verity was an Inquisitor spec. And there
goes... Sometimes you just gotta throw a Hail Mary down the field and see what happens.
Yeah. So, yeah, that is an interesting swap up there. So we have a 4-0 sweep, and 1v1 owned is the champions of the Godlike Arena Season 2. So, did you guys
Congratulations, guys. That was good showing.
Yes.
Congrats, guys.
And that is our winners, Ganked and Norxy in Revert. Which is a pretty cool composition. We had Dominator win this time.
I was kind of hoping Gank's team would win. Out of all the contestants, I think he knew Jemar the most.
All right, so the official standings, we have 1v1 owned with Ganked and Norxy and Revert are the champions. Second place is Kawhi, which... As the guy that I can't pronounce his name, El Cinixo.
They're getting on the podiums over there if you want to shift your screen. It's behind us.
All right. And then we have
Who was in third place?
And also Verity and Velvish in the second place. And the third place is Two Deeps, One Cup, which is Cupcakey, Crumbonic, and Naked Stone. And there you have your champions on the top podium there. Congratulations, 1v1 Ganked. And, man, you guys won a lot of stuff. Let's see. The winning team there won 6 wrecks. 6 of the 160% token tablets. RG's prize package, which is just way too much stuff to read right now because RG donated a lot. Thank you very much, RG. And Ocho's prize pack, which is 3 of the 2.7 soul codes. And prizes for second place is 3 wrecks, 3 of the 160% token tablets. And prizes for third place is 300 platinum. So very, very cool. They won a ton of stuff. And since we are about to wrap this up with the last giveaway... We do need to tell you guys that if you want to win more of the soul bundles, make sure that you go to this website and subscribe to that awesome person that posts all Rift content and all PvP content. If that's what you like, then that's the channel to subscribe to. And in the last 4 videos that I posted, I am giving away a... soul bundle in each one of them, all provided by Godlike Awesomeness, the awesome people that are running this tournament. They're providing all the prizes, all the stuff, I mean, except for the RG prize package and what Tryon is giving away in the first place spot. They provided everything out of their own pocket. So guys, show them some love if you can. And also, I would like to thank Landslide for helping me commentate, and also Crystal and Kiwi. You guys have been absolutely awesome in helping out with all of this. And one last promotion before we do the giveaway and take screenshots and all that good stuff. There is another tournament coming up, and it's Rough Raptors Tourney, which is a 5v5. If you guys want more information on that, visit the forums and go to the PvP forums.
You cut out and vent.
Yeah, they can hear me in live stream, though. Go to the post that Rough Raptors posted on the PvP channel, PvP forums, and make sure that you check it out and participate if you can. If you can get four other friends to help win, Tryon is providing prizes for that one. So, yeah, check it out. All right. There's our winners, and we will be doing the giveaway in just a second. All right, let's do a giveaway. This is for the Rex, and congratulations to our winners. All right, leave a message in the chat area, guys. Leave a message now. And thank you very much to Mystery Mix. He was in my ear the entire time helping me commentate this, even though you couldn't see him. I did, and he helped me so, so much. All right, let's do this giveaway. Make sure you're following the live stream and make sure that you show Godlike Awesomeness lots of love, specifically Allogel and Kalia. They are absolutely awesome people. All right, are you following the live stream? Are you following the live stream or... Okay, drawing now. Hurry up, post in the live stream. We're about to do the drawing so everybody can wrap this up and go to bed and hand out prizes. It's giving you guys one more second. Hurry up. Post in the chat. Make sure you're following. And the giveaway starts now. Bam! Okay. Somebody's not following the live stream. Theus, you are not following the live stream. Congratulations, sir, for being the loser in this contest.
That's kind of funny.
Wasn't he trolling in the chat earlier? But, yeah. All right, we're going to the next one. Be sure to be following the live stream, guys. Bam, rolling again, and the winner is Court Kyle is following the live stream, and the rule is you must respond to me in 30 seconds. If you are currently watching the live stream, you will be the winner. So give me a reply, let me know that you're watching, you didn't go to bed and leave the live stream on. Following is overrated. That it possibly is very true.
Looks like somebody didn't have enough coffee.
Uh-oh. You got about 15 seconds. And he replies. Congratulations, sir. And I will be sending every winner a message on Twitch tomorrow morning or so. Yeah. All right, guys. I guess we're going to wrap it up. Thank you, everybody that tuned in. Thank you to everybody that helped me commentate it. And especially thank you to Godlike Awesomeness for putting on this wonderful event and asking me to commentate it once again. I hope you guys enjoyed my commentary. I know early on it was a little bit slow, but we got the pace rolling as we went along. So, yeah. I hope everybody enjoyed, and we will be seeing you for the next Godlike Arena, Part 3. So, yep. Take care, guys.
Thanks, guys, for having me along and allowing me to sit in. I look forward to doing the next tournament with you guys, and I will be putting up some loots from SIRadio.fm.
Guys, make sure you take part in that. Yes, what all are you giving away? Can you spoil any of it right now, or?
No spoilers.
Okay, no spoilers. All right. So
it'll be good. But I am going to run. I've got my set tomorrow, early afternoon. I had a lot of fun, and I learned a lot. So thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you so much for helping me commentate, and I will see you all next time. And the live stream is cutting out now.
Yeah, good times. See y'all later.